Oh, hello, space friends. How are you going? Are you guys excited for a little bit of internet spaceships tonight? I'm CCP Convict. I'm a community developer at EVE Online, and we thought we'd put together this special broadcast for you guys because clear skies is something that's near and dear to the heart of many capsuleers and many people at CCP, myself included. And to make it really special and put it over the top, we thought that we would invite a special guest on the show to talk to you guys about the product. And it's none other than the man himself, the one who was responsible for all this. He's the creator, the writer, the voice actor, the stunt coordinator, the caterer. And it's Ian Chisholm. How are you going, mate?
Hello. Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
We can hear you. If you're in struggle town with voice in two places, you should mute the Twitch stream and listen through to my dulcet tones through Discord only. All right. Well, we're here. So it's been 12 years since the first Clear Skies movie debuted. Almost 12 years to the day, in fact. Well, not quite. It's, what is it? May, I think, is when it first launched. And right now we're sitting in a Twitch chat with 700 people in it. Ian, can you believe that Clear Skies, the popularity has persisted over such a long period of time?
No. In a word, it's crazy. Even after well over a decade, I think, since the first one came out, I still find people are quoting lines. And I've been watching the Twitch chat, and it's just crazy how many people, I think they know the words better than I do these days.
Well, people have been gathering in Twitch chat since about 2 hours before the broadcast actually started, and I think at least a dozen people have written, like, how long? So,
yeah, someone said my mic's too loud. Is it too loud? I can turn it down.
I'll turn it down on my end, if that's all right with you. Give me a second. Brilliant.
How noisy am I now?
I've turned Ian down a little bit, so I'll keep an eye on chat. It might take us a little while just to get everything leveled out just right, but you should be a little bit quieter now. Oh, people are saying good, so that's awesome.
Okay.
So Clear Skies came out in 2008, and then a year later you released Clear Skies 2. So since it was only 12 months between the two movies, I guess it's fair to say that they're pretty easy to make and don't take that long to put together.
You joke, surely.
Yeah, I do. Because my understanding is the original Clear Skies took you almost 4 years.
Yeah, I mean, I'd never done anything like it before. So think of every aspect to do with making a film and then learn it all from the word go without knowing if you could actually do it or not. I mean, if I'd have known how long it was going to take me before I started it, I wouldn't have started it.
Was it literally like a shower thought for you? Like, you're one day you're like, I'm going to make a 36 minute long EVE machinima, but now I need to figure out how to make machinima.
The trigger was I made a few EVE vids like other people had done, where you record like in game footage and then you put it together to music. And that was great. And then I got super frustrated because you couldn't tell a story. And I've always liked to be able to tell a story. And I was just mucking about one day with some footage of going out hooning around in a couple of mates' cars, and this guy just happened to have a blue car, and I was messing about with all the different special effects you could apply, and I found chroma key blue screening, and I thought, oh, let's give this a try. What have I got lying around that I can chroma key on? Hey, look, it's a bit of warp footage from EVE Online. And I just put it on, and then it just suddenly occurred to me of like, well, hang on a minute, I've built levels in Half-Life 2 and the original Half-Life before. And I just thought, like, I could build the interior sets and control the people. So I did a quick test, and I was so ridiculously excited, I was almost shaking trying to put together this crappy set of, like, the Tempest Battleship, which just happened to be what I was flying in the game. And then I blue-screened on the warping footage through, and it was just like, holy smoke, you know, this could be a thing. And that was what kicked me off. But then, you know, I know the old adage is like, there's three important things for a film, and that's the script and the script. So the first thing I had to do was write it without a clue what I was doing, and then work out how to do everything else, question mark, profit. You know, easy, really.
That old chestnut.
Yeah. And it took me like, 1,500 hours, something like that?
Wow.
2,500, I can't remember. But I do remember uploading it to e-files, because like YouTube wasn't pretty much even a thing back then.
Yeah, yeah. E-files still around. Thank you, Cripper.
Yeah, he loves me. and I just thought like, oh, if it gets like 1,000 views, then, you know, maybe as many people have spent time watching it that I have spent making it, and I would be quite happy about it. And it just went ballistic. You know, I was expecting 10 replies in the forum, maybe going, oh, yeah, it's all right, something different, and then move on. And fine, it was just a creative outlet. 3 days later, I'm writing Clear Skies 2. So,
you're like, oh, yeah, there's a market for this.
Yeah, this
well, I'm giving away for free.
By popular demand was a phrase that sprang to mind.
No, that makes sense. And it wasn't just the EVE community either, was it? Like, I'm to understand Clear Skies actually won some legitimate awards.
Yeah, it was good. I put it into a couple of competitions that I found for Machinima that used to run back in the day. And a really cool thing happened. Number one, I won, which was great. And they even gave me a 3D printed a 3D printed trophy, which was pretty new back then. And they posted it all the way from the States. And the guy who was running it, it was really great. I got an email from him out of the blue, and he said, I'm one of the judges, so I really shouldn't be doing this because it hadn't been judged yet. But he replied saying, like, I've seen hundreds of Machinima, and yours was such a breath of fresh air.
Oh, that's just awesome.
How well it's been put together.
I thought it was going to be like, hey, I play EVE as well or something.
No,
like that.
He just said, I just had to let you know. And it wasn't for a while later that I realized who this Ricky Grove person was who'd written to me saying how good it was. And it's actually, it's Ricky Grove who he's a genuine Hollywood actor. He was Henry the Red in Army of Darkness. If anybody remembers that from the Evil Dead trilogy.
Right.
And we've been friends ever since, really. And he played a character in Clear Skies 3 as well. He played Fallon Houseman. So, and sort of acted us all off the page. But yeah, that was really, really super. And people just generally in sci-fi liked it, because I tried to make it a story about the people with parts of Eve in it.
Yeah. Oh, at the end of the day, that's the fundamental part of any story, isn't it? Of anything you'd produce. It's the story, it's the relationships, characters, and things like that. It just happens to be set in EVE and borrow a little bit of technology from Half-Life 2. But using EVE as a framework was such a cool thing, because I think what made Clear Skies like really sort of stick with me was that I think everyone who plays EVE can see a little bit of their own experience in what the crew goes through throughout the movies, and use so many tropes from the game, you know, like gate camps and things like that, that we would encounter. It immediately makes it identifiable and really brings it home.
Yeah, it was write what you know, which is an important thing.
Sure.
And because it's my mates doing voice acting, then they've never done it before. Basically, it's us being us. We're sniping at each other and being idiots. So for the most part, it was easy to get a performance of some sort out of them. We'll gloss over Clear Skies 1's voice acting abilities, but it just kind of worked from there. And then like, I progressed as a director throughout the series and found that I had have a knack of getting a performance out of someone who's not done it before. I kind of know the steps to go through to relax them. Even if it's a bottle and a half of beer or a couple of glasses of wine,
you're perfect level of inebriated. You got to get loosen those inhibitions and shake it up a little bit.
Yeah, it's like I'm brilliant at bowling if I've had 1.5 pints of beer.
Yeah,
if I sober up or I have 2 pints, I'm useless.
Same with me and playing pool. There's like a bell curve, you know. Like,
yeah, it's really thin.
That's right. It is. It doesn't last very long. It's really hard to find that point and stick at it. We'll jump.
Said Gmod. Someone said Gmod in the chat. Drayden
yeah.
T.
Yeah, they know how to trick you.
Half-Life 2 Source Engine, not Gary's Mod.
That actually segues nicely because I was just about to say we'll start with the first movie soon, but I had one last question that I wanted to ask you about the technology that you use for Clear Skies 2 because we're talking about, well, Half-Life 2 came out in 2004. If memory serves you correctly, or maybe 2003, Eve came out in the same year. So, like, things back then were never particularly user-friendly to begin with, let alone with the kind of hardware that you had to work on at the day. So what were the tools that you used, and how did you manage to pull it all together, and what other things did you have to pull in, third-party and so on, to get those two to match up?
Oh, God. Well, obviously, I used Eve Online. For the first two, it was just plain old using my mouse and filming it live in game. I recorded with Fraps, and that was a real pain in the backside because the slightest mistake, you know, those ships in Eve were never designed to sit in one place like exactly. So that was a bit of a nightmare. And I used Half-Life 2 Source Engine and the Hammer map editor to build the sets, and these god-awful stuff called Face Poser to control the lip sync and the face animation and stuff. And there wasn't much more to it, actually. I can't even remember the name of the video editor I used to nail together the first one, but I switched to Sony Vegas for the second one and haven't really looked back from that product. It's on version 17 now, which I...
You're on the beta or something. That's
people think I'm like super cutting edge with this stuff, but I'm not. I just sort of use it to produce the product. I don't give a darn about like the software that I use as long as it does the job. Case example, the audio editing software is Cool Edit 96. Now, the clue is in the number there.
Yeah.
That was released in 1996. And I still use it today because it's audio. It does everything I want it to do. I'm familiar with the user interface, and I can absolutely motor along. So why
software from 1996 is very evocative of the technology used in Mimitar ships as well.
Yeah, that is true. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's get the first movie up and running. Originally, the plan was that Ian would be doing like a director commentary, doing the movies themselves. But what's emerged is... there's quite a lot of people who are going to be viewing who have never seen these before, and they'll be seeing them here for the first time. So rather than have the running director commentary throughout the episodes, we're just going to run the movies. But Ian is in Twitch chat. What was the name of your Twitch handle again there, Ian?
It's a long but unique name.
Yes, but what's the handle? Oh, that's right. It's literally a long
Very
but
funny.
Unique name. Thank you. So, a long but unique name.
Oh, hang on. Arnie the Viking. Just one moment. No, it's 5.541 is my version of Winamp.
Oh. I'm running 1.666, I think, was the last one I used.
Okay. Let's go, shall we? They're getting restless.
Yeah. I'll kick off the movie. So you guys,
Second one's better. If you've never seen them before, the second one's better. Stick with it.
Don't be shy. Ian will be chatting to you guys, answering questions, and just saying any interesting things related to what you're seeing on the screen. So give him a poke and just have a chat with him and enjoy your time and enjoy Clear Skies 1.
How much?
About 30 million, Mr. Rourke.
30 million isk.
Yes, sir.
That's practically a new ship.
Clear Skies will practically be a new ship when she's fixed, sir.
But I don't want a new ship. I want this one back as it was.
There isn't, frankly, much left of the current vessel. Perhaps sir shouldn't have got it quite so badly damaged.
Hey, I didn't damage it. I wasn't the one shooting at it. Believe me, I was trying to avoid the damage.
Alas, sir, the damage didn't avoid you, and the repairs stand at 30 million isk.
Why don't I just strap an armour repair on and go clog up the outside of the station? That doesn't cost 30 million.
Sir, as I have explained already, it's not just the armour. Your superstructure is in dire need of reinforcing and renovation, as well as most of the internal system.
Yeah, I know what you said. Still, at least if I'm paying that much, you'll have it ready fast, right?
3 weeks, sir.
How long?
Have they fixed it yet? Ooh, have they fixed it yet? Have they fixed it yet? Have they fixed it yet?
Try to quell your surprise, Charlie, but they have in fact finally finished welding Clear Skies back together. Jump up and clap hands with glee.
Oh, will miracles never cease?
It's hardly a miracle. They didn't take this long even after that Amarian slave trader shot the top wingy bit off a couple of years back.
Top wingy bit?
Well, hull breaches will do that to a ship's internal structure. Now, on to the more pressing matter of cash flow.
It's got a proper name, you know.
Yeah, the target.
Basically, we have no cash, and thus no flow.
So pretty much the last few years of grubbing around and getting our asses shot off has amounted to us sat here, bored to skin and with no charter. Champion. All we own is a ship that looks like an explosion in a girder factory.
Yeah, that and the tales to tell in the bars, come on, you mustn't forget them. Anyway, with a fully refitted ship, we can look for a charter, and I've got good news and bad news on that front.
Oh, I?
Yeah, the good news is, I've got some idiot in a shiny suit. He wants ferrying 9 jumps across the fringes of Empire Space, and he only wants to go in a battleship-class vessel, which means we feature highly in his plans, especially as you don't normally get them docked around here. And he's also willing to pay 30 million quid.
How much?
Flat kind of cash he could buy his own ship.
Exactly, which brings us to the bad news.
Which is?
Some idiot in a shiny suit is willing to pay massively over the odds to get ferried 9 jumps through Empire Space and apparently needs a battleship to do it, which can only mean one thing.
It's a death trap.
It's a death trap.
So what else is there available?
Some job-shifting cans of quaff about in-system for not enough money to even charge the capacitor, and that really is it. Seems like we picked the worst place to hold up in 10 jumps, but what with the ship's lack of ability to hold air in at the time, I guess we can't complain. Face it, lads, we don't really have a lot of choice. Either sell Clear Skies and go back to a cruiser, try and work our way back up again like the bad old days, or take on the death trap job.
We've only just had this ship put back into one piece. Paint isn't dry yet. I don't want to scratch the moment we undock, okay?
I'll take that as a vote for the trap of death. Charlie?
Oh, I'm gunnery. I don't care. Probably means that once again I'll be justifying my place on board.
What, you mean like the last time? How quickly we forget.
Right, sorted then. I'll contact the shiny suited idiot and tell him he's got a place on our ship. Then I'll check the insurance. Yes, sir.
Since when have we ever had insurance?
Since when indeed?
Okay, I've discussed it with my crew and I'm happy to say you've got a place on our ship, Mr...
You can call me Mr. Smith.
Huh, and here we are, thousands of years down the line since Eve Day 1, and yet people still use Mr. Smith when wishing to remain anonymous.
Possibly I use it because that is my name.
Yeah, well, as long as the fund's clear, you can call yourself Eleanor Gatsky as far as I'm concerned.
The funds will clear. Half now, half on arrival. Standard Metropolis contract terms.
Assuming we make it intact. What's the destination?
The system of Heck.
unfortunately.
Okay, Sol, you got that?
Yep. Heck, you say. Right, let's have a shafty. Hedion, Hemon. Ah, heck, there it is. Looks like it's about 10 jumps from here. That's about an hour.
Excellent. Can we leave right away?
Sure, I can't see why not.
You have a sofa on the bridge of a ship. That's very eccentric.
Yeah, well, this ship's pretty much my home, and I'm not one for holing up in cabins. I like to sit out here and look at the stars.
Ah, someone holed up in an office for most of the time. I can understand that.
If you like the sofa that much, you can have it in your office for 200.
What have I told you before about trying to sell my sofa, Burke?
You're right. You can have it for nothing.
Alas, my office is far too small for such an artifact. And on that note, gentlemen, I shall retire to my cabin and take some medication. Warp drive does affect my stomach, so, and I prefer to sleep through it.
Righto, let's get undocked and see what bits fall off the ship.
Clear skies, this is Station CNC. You are go for undock and warp.
Roger that, CNC.
And I'll see you later in the contract pages.
You got it, John. Try and bring it back intact next time. Station out.
That's odd. Yeah, everything looks sort of... Oh, they must have cleaned the windows or something.
They are undocked. The cargo is on board. They're on their way to you.
You know, I just don't know why Smith has a problem. I mean, how can gate travel upset you, Storm?
Warp drive active.
So, to my surprise, everything's working first go.
That's a first.
Yeah, looks like these repairs were money well spent and they took the time commissioning it all correctly. You should remember the place that did this. Except, of course, the light above my console's flickering.
I thought you said everything was working first go.
Well, the major systems, yes, but we've still got dodgy lights, wiring, plumbing, door motors, lift controls, the sink is backing up, and don't ask what happened to Sol in the shower. We've routed that lubricant line correctly now.
Yeah, but to be fair, it was like that before we got shot at.
It was like that before we bought it. It's Minmatar.
So, how are we stacked out then in case anything, you know, goes wrong?
Well, I've got a torch.
No, I mean if we get attacked, not if your console light goes out.
Ah, well, the shield's pretty good. I've specced out a good all-round system that is strong against most types of attack. We've got emergency boosters to reinforce it if we need to. The speed's pretty good and I managed to fit some top-line trackers and stabilisers for the guns.
Oh, speaking of which, did they have your favourites?
Oh yeah, take a look. Top of the line 1400mm howitzers. Biggest damn things we can strap on. Takes a while to cycle the action, but the range and stopping power is second to none. Most things tend to get the message when their shields fail after only one volley.
We never do.
Yeah, well, true. But unless you start specialising in one job, this is the best multi-role setup I've ever found for this ship. And I've noticed we don't tend to specialise.
Did you get any of that ammo you were on about?
The tremor stuff? Oh yeah, imported from Jitter, and this is some of my favourites. Doubles the range and hits hard. Only trouble is it weighs a goddamn much. It's almost faster to turn the ship than the guns. To be used on stationary targets only, I'm afraid.
Ah, my favourite kind.
You expecting targets, then?
I always expect targets. You should always expect targets. Your gunnery.
Yeah. Trouble is, JR, as ever, it gets more difficult to prepare for all the possibilities out there. The universe has changed since we started, and the number of specialised ships just keeps on increasing. You know I can't cover all eventualities with a one-on-one engagement these days.
I know that. I just ask you to prepare the best we can.
Okay, and what if it's multiple targets? It usually is. When was the last time you saw just one ship at a gate?
Look, Charlie, I know where this is going, so just forget about it.
I'm just saying that in this day and age, it's usually better to have, well, some backup.
We've got backup. What about Cormark? What about Haffa, huh?
They aren't really backup, JR. They're just some strange people we know. They aren't ever even in the same system, so even if they do respond, we have to wait for them to show up.
And they always do?
Eventually. Sometimes we need backup there and then. Cast your mind back to about 3 weeks ago. We nearly died, Johnny.
Yeah, I know what happened, Charlie. I was there, remember?
And here we are, skint, with a highly suspicious job on and no backup. Again.
Oh, so this is going back to signing up for a corporation then, is it, huh? Some faceless bunch of idiots who spend the whole time bickering before screwing you over for every isk you've got. And when they say jump, you have to jump because they own your ass.
At the moment, John, when you say jump, we have to jump or it is our ass. In a corp, you get a paycheck, some security and stability, and a whole corporate fleet behind you when the going gets tough. Big difference. And for all the freedom you talk about in this crew, it's gotten us changed to a dangerous operation that we can't refuse because we never have any goddamn money.
Hey, Charlie, if you don't like it, why don't you just sign up with Caldari Provisions and stack shelves for a living, eh?
It's a good job someone's paying attention to the damn scanner for the last five jumps because, ladies, at this gate is a very suspicious formation of ships waiting for us. I suggest you come to the bridge. Quick!
What you got, Sol?
One missile boat damage dealer, Raven-class battleship, supported by Blackbird EW and a tackler frigate.
Damn it, that's a setup.
You're right, it's getting worse. The gate guns are offline and the local channel is clear of anyone but us four. Whoever these guys are, they've got some influence.
They have confidence too. That's not the biggest gate camp I've ever seen.
Confidence or secrecy, this smells of a black op. You've got low numbers and nasty people who are keeping their mouths shut.
Nasty people who are locking us up too.
Right, so get to engineering and start warming up the warp drive. Put us on alignment for nearest gravity where we can target. I don't care what it is. Chart safe spot en route and prep for a double back. You know the drill. Charlie, get to gunnery and look lively. Bounce a lock back to them and take the safeties off the 1400s. We may need to distract them while they withdraw.
Ain't no better distraction than that.
Lining up on planet 4.
Safety's off, locking up all three hostiles.
Ah, damn it. That tackler stuck a graviton beam straight to the warp core, John. It's hit the limiters and have gone offline. We didn't get the speed in time.
We aren't going to hit him with these guns either. It's way too small and fast.
In that case, focus on that Blackbird before...
I've lost lock. We're jammed.
Cycle time.
10 seconds, but it's off the scale. Our sensors are swamped. No chance of punching through it. It'll catch us every cycle.
Not that it really matters, lads. I'm picking up a local distortion field building up as well.
Is it a Weber?
Yep, and there it is. We can push about 20 metres a second now, and that's your lot. We ain't going anywhere.
And we're not shooting back either. Now what?
Oh, well, now I'll make a call to our backup.
sad reflection on our lifestyle when you got a pre-recorded message begging for help. The Raven captain's opening up comms with us.
Put him on.
John Rock.
Well, clearly I'm more famous than you, mate, because I don't know your name.
I'll make this simple just for you. Hand over your cargo or die.
Huh, you know, Quaife isn't that expensive in the shops, and 300 cubic metres of the stuff's going to rot your teeth as well.
What are you talking about?
My cargo. It's Quaife. You know, the popular drink sold in all stations in your region.
Obviously, I didn't make things simple enough. We know you have a Mr. Smith on board. Hand him over or you die.
Oh, Mr. Smith. Right. Why exactly do you want him badly enough to shut down our whole system and threaten us?
That's not your concern.
It's certainly not the concern of a frozen corpse either. And I don't care which particular unconcerned thing I leave him awake. Now give me Smith.
But Mr. Smith's been with us for years.
What?
My cuddly toy mascot bear, Mr. Smith. He's been on the ship for years. He brings us luck, although I'm beginning to suspect I should check which type.
I think you've upset him.
I know you've upset him.
The way he disconnected in the sulk?
Nope, the way he launched torpedoes at us.
Well, that's just plain rude. What's your assessment, Charlie?
They're hitting us with old school explosives, and a lot of them, which is a shame as the shields are tuned. Reflect and rebound, not stop pressure waves.
Damn it. How are our shields holding out, Salt?
Kind of stressed they are.
I'm boosting them off storage, but it's not going to last forever.
Have you sped up the hardness?
Of course I have. It's making a difference, but not enough of one.
Are we going to tank it or not?
Tank it? Hardly. They'll be down in 2 minutes of this. It's a different level of abuse.
2 minutes? Are you sure?
Of course I am. The shockwaves are already starting to affect the armour plating. The shields are down to 20%. Stop asking me stupid questions and start getting us the hell out of here.
Goodbye, Mr. Smith, or whoever you are.
I'm sat doing nothing here, so can you please get tracking back online?
Look, I'm having a hard enough time trying to keep the ship intact, thanks. And anyway, no, we haven't got sensor boosters.
JR, we may as well throw these 40 punches at them for all the goddamn good they're doing. Where the hell is our so-called backup?
That's what I'd like to know. The shields are just about... No, mate, that they're down.
Come on, Cor, come on.
Shields are down, Rourke. Shields are down. I bet you're not so smug now while your Matari bucket of bolts falls apart around you. Keep firing!
The armor's half gone and I'm starting to pick up hull beats across the ship. Seb, this is commanding to start to lose control function.
We've got a signal on the local channel. This should be our backup.
It'd damn better be the blessed finest just went offline.
That makes our hull look like tinfoil. That's bad.
No, what's bad is that next torpedo seems to be coming my way.
That one's coming through the wall. Run!
I'm way ahead of you. Well, that's my exercise done for the week.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'll head to engineering.
I've got the shields back up to 5%, but that's a lot. The cap's dead.
You alright, lads? You having some problems?
Take that damn heron out, Cor. He's got us locked down big time. We need to get out of here while we've still got a ship to get out.
What? No? Hello? No? How are you?
Shut up and hurry up. We're in bad shape here.
Yeah. I'm already on it.
Who the hell's this? We weren't told he had backup. Is this just some local chancer?
Okay, lads, he's down. Light your fire and go.
Warp core has just moved out and navigation is back online. I'm winding up the coils now.
Good. Bounce us off the planet, get us somewhere safe. Then we see about fixing the damn ship again.
I'll go get the dustpan and brush.
Fully fixed! It was fully fixed! Better than ever! And now, almost instantly, it's wrecked again. I knew it was going to be a trap, but I didn't expect a whole system to be locked down. Who do they think they are?
And why are they so interested in Smith? To go all that trouble and actually try and get the guy alive? Maybe we should just pop him out in a cargo pod.
We'll not get another charter in this region if we fold up like that, and you know it. Is he even still alive after all that?
Yeah, his life signs are fine. Those pills he took must be potent. He's still asleep. Want me to go wake him up?
No, don't bother. He'll either wake up at the station and give us a cash or he'll never wake up again along with the rest of us. Anyway, he doesn't strike me as the type to stay calm in this sort of situation, and the last thing we need is
some suit panicking.
Well, our plot is a course that will backtrack us to the station we came from. I'm hoping they haven't got the durometer gate covered, otherwise we're in big trouble.
Durometer gate? The hell with that? We're finishing this job.
How can we do that?
Set a course for Amori.
You can't get there without going through that gate.
Set us a course for Amori.
And that'll just get us killed, so forget it,
we're
John.
Going through this system, that gate.
In what? Attractive
and we're
being
going
wrecked?
Through them if they get in the way again.
Oh, well, that's a well thought out plan.
So, not only do we now need the cash more than ever, but we do not run away. You know that, and I know that. Besides, they took chunks out of our ship, so we got to make them pay for that.
Yeah, true, but exactly how do we do that now that they've only got half a ship? They kicked their ass when we had a whole one. The jammer's still there, so we won't be able to fire. What are we going to do? Shout at them?
Charlie, do the guns still work?
Well, yeah, they should do, seeing as they haven't been fired yet. All the gunnery systems are green. Ish.
Then we'll have everything we need.
What? This wrecking an interceptor? I've got to agree with Solomon. Even if we could fire our guns, that completely intact and undamaged battleship will rip us apart.
Charles, that battleship will have a surprise coming that is going to work out in our favour. I've got more than one pre-recorded message begging for help.
Eeny? Meeny? Miney?
Damn it!
Right, he's on his way. You guys get whatever repairs that need doing done and make it fast.
I guess I'll start up that massive hole in what used to be the bridge. Anything else? Maybe clean the windows again?
Just sort out enough stuff to get us up to combat readiness. I'll go check over the rest of the ship.
Right, okay, fine. Combat readiness? That's a laugh.
Need a hand?
Can do. I believe we're going back.
He's not happy. I prefer the nice and happy JR, not the angry one. Left a bit.
Idiot's gonna get us killed. Get us combat worthy? Yeah, okay then. I'll swap the ship for Titan. That should do it.
Well, if anyone can fix it, it's Solomon, 25 years in the Caldari Navy, Burke.
23 and a half, and don't try to flatter me, fodder. You know it doesn't work. Aren't you concerned about this at all?
What? Your ability to remote control a robot carrying an 800mm thick plate of steel? No, not at all.
No, the whole getting killed as a point of honour we don't run thing.
Nah, you know me. How bad is all this anyway? We got power for the guns.
The capacitor's damaged and it's charging slow even if the extra cable runs bodged in. Your guns don't use it though, so they'll keep firing until they fall off the ship. The armor's pretty much gone, and I've got the shields back up to full power. It's a tough ship, but it's still not good. Whoever this help is, they better be on time and useful.
In a situation like this, the help's probably going to be Haffa.
Oh great, help from someone who scares me.
Well, at least he'll help keep both the top and bottom wingy bits on. That's got to count for something.
Do you want me to weld the cabin doors shut with this thing? Because I can, you know. How many times have I got to tell you those parts of a ship have a correct name? Well?
Sir, no report of any Minotaur-class battleships at the other gate.
Have we got a scan probe ship available?
No, sir. That wasn't part of our tactical package.
Neither were his reinforcements. Very well, we'll play the waiting game. That heap of Rorks is already leaking air, so I don't anticipate much of a problem whether he decides to run or fight.
Okay, JR, your control functions are patched into the console that hasn't been blown up. The capacitor's charging about as fast as it's going to without a dock refit, and most of the red lights are out on other systems.
Nice one, Sol.
Bear it in mind, our armour's pretty much gone, although I've got the binders back online, so at least I'll stop the hull breaches like the last one. Well, for a bit.
Gotcha.
Based on the tacticals from the last fight, we've got about 2 minutes for our shields to the deck. You reckon we can take them down before then? Our armour will fold up at the first real sign of abuse.
I intend on having as long as I like to take him out. Don't you worry. Right, Cormac, you ready?
Yep, as always.
Your target
the Blackbird. Yeah, I'm on it.
Good.
Are you sure about this?
Very. Get to your stations and gang warp us in.
Cormac, we're going into gang warp now.
Charlie?
Yeah?
You know that expensive ammo you spent a week in Jeddah waiting for?
Yeah?
Time to use it.
Oh yeah.
Sir, we are picking up a warp signature in this vicinity.
Surely he isn't going to face us again.
No messing this time, Charlie. Lock him up and fire everything we own as quick as you can. Salt, disable the thermal cutoffs on everything.
Overheat him if you have to.
Locking up in 3, 2, 1, firing.
Sir, they are firing some sort of exotic ammunition at us.
Really? Well, fire some of our non-exotic missiles back.
Still achieving lock, sir. 8 seconds.
Why isn't our jammer stopping them?
Cool, how you doing?
Me? I'm having a ball. That Blackbird pilot is in such a panic, he's forgotten the jammer he wants. It's made of old quake gun, so it shouldn't take too long.
The Blackbird pilot is requesting permission to leave the battle. He's receiving structural damage.
Ignore that, Aegis. How much damage are we taking because that fool can't do this one job?
Shields will last another minute at this rate of fire, sir.
Sir, the controller at the barometer gate has reported a local beacon activating, but no corresponding gate activation and there is no response.
Does it look like I can? My traffic report, you fool. Just keep firing.
JR, the jammer's down, but my guns are dry. I wouldn't scratch that Raven anyway, so I'm out of here.
Yeah, thanks, Cor. I owe you one.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about it. I'll bill you for it. But fly safe.
Huh? Well, yeah, okay.
You know what I mean. Fly safe once people have stopped hurling missiles at you.
I'll see you in station.
Well, that's great news, Joe. But our shields aren't going to last much longer.
Tactical shows that we're going to be in armour before that Raven will be. He's got a full complement. Thought we could take as long as we'd like.
Shields are down again, Rourke, and this time your armour won't save. What in Divinity's Edge? What the hell is that?
Sir, it's targeted us and
unleash an experimental electronic warfare. Somebody up top underestimated these people.
Cease fire, Charlie. Let's see what he has to say now.
I heard about these next generation chips, but I didn't think they were in active military use yet.
Never mind in the general population.
They aren't. It's stolen. So, you want to tell me what this was all about while you still can?
You don't know who you're messing with. This is too big for some privateer nobody. Next time there'll be a fleet waiting for you, and no amount of cloaker freaks will pull you out of the fire, Rourke.
Oh, that's mighty big talk from someone locked down by a cloaker freak and locked up by a privateer nobody.
You'll find out about Smith one way or the other, and it's going to go hard on you. I'll let my superiors know that you chose poorly.
Your superiors aren't going to hear anything about this, especially not from you.
It'll go better for you if you let me go.
Yeah, I really don't think I can believe that.
Because, let me see, it would involve trusting someone who just tried to kill me and my crew twice.
Don't worry, I won't be trying a third time.
I'll be lucky to have a cleaning job after this disaster.
Ah, but I must now consider you a mortal enemy because you took it upon yourself to attack me and mine. This ends now, no matter what you say.
Don't be ridiculous, this was a paid job.
No matter what you say, there is only one way to make sure I and my crew can sleep sound at night now, and it's your fault I have to do it.
Wait, the, no...
All guns, fire.
No!
Well, thanks for your help, Heffa.
Are we even yet?
No.
Yeah, whatever. Well, that was awkward.
What exactly is it between those two?
They were friends once. I think Jai helped him pinch that freaky ship.
What? RJR?
Yeah, funny to think, eh? I think something went wrong in the raid, though, because Heffa always says that "are we even yet" thing.
Even for what?
Dunno. Don't want to know.
Okay, let's see if we can finish this run without hitting any more trouble, shall we?
So will the engine start, or shall I get out and push?
Hey Station, I hope you've got space in your dock for one ship and your bar for three people.
That's an affirmative, Clear Skies, although it only looks like half a ship to us.
Yeah, tow us in and send me the contract pages. I need another job to pay for this one.
Okay, sir. Dock port 3 is open.
Well, I guess that's another tale to tell in the bars, eh?
Ah, are we there? I feel quite refreshed.
Oh, so you slept okay then?
Oh yes. I'm sure I started this journey on a complete battleship.
Yeah, and I'm sure I started this journey as a transport job.
Meaning?
Meaning you didn't pass for escort duty, and you knew there would be trouble.
I would have thought a rather generous payoff should have hinted towards it being somewhat non-standard charter.
You could have warned us exactly how much trouble was waiting for us. Your ass was on the line as well, you know.
Mr. Rourke, I assure you I had no idea what was waiting for us. I didn't expect it to be so organised.
Ah, so you knew it was organised. I thought you slept through it all,
In my line, Mr. Rourke, one learns to be a very light sleeper. Your funds have been transferred. I look forward to doing business with you again.
I don't think so, Mr. Smith. Those people are connected up harder than I ever want to see.
Oh, Mr. Rourke, don't misunderstand me. That was a statement, not a question or a request. Those were not the only people connected up high, and there are difficult times ahead. Yes, indeed, difficult times for everyone.
Yeah, well, we aren't everyone. Well, we're undocking after only 2 weeks this time.
So now what? The cash we've got only just covers the repairs, again, and yet another job hauling Quaid just to charge the cap.
Yeah, we seem to keep going in circles here. Never have any cash left over. What's the point?
Well, we've got the adventure. There are a lot of people that are envious of that, you know.
I envy people that've got money left over after they've repaired their ship.
Well, I've got nowhere else to go, so here I am.
So we're stuck with you, no matter how many times JR tries to get us killed.
Oi, Charlie, we're still here, aren't we? You know, there's always tomorrow.
No, I don't know. What that Mr. Smith said about us seeing him again. Can't help but feel there's a big cloud on the horizon.
No, you're worrying too much. No clouds on this horizon. We've got clear skies.
Ah, the feels. We've got clear skies. That was fantastic, Ian. I have to ask you a question, though. In the final credits, there's a shout-out to someone named Andy Carter, and you're saying, this is how you finish a project. What's the story of that?
You can hear me, yeah? Just before I start waffling on.
I can what, sorry?
Is it working?
Oh, yeah, no, I think it
you can hear me.
Yep.
Good. Yeah, he's actually in the chat. He's Hope for Sun. In the chat. Say hello, Andy, if you're still listening. If you're not in the toilet or something. There he is. yeah, he's a big creative guy. And he takes on more than he can do. It's been a running joke for like 15 years now. I say you can do 1.5 big projects in your life and real life as well. And he tends to try 4. I forgot I even put that in.
I've often wondered about that one myself. It's like, it's a really good snub there right at the end. It's like, how do you like them apples? And it gets even better now because we've got 1,000 people watching this like some 12 years later as well.
God,
so it's like, there you go. Yeah, wow. Yeah. So it's like, yeah, there you go. There you go, Andy. I guess he sure showed you.
So I've been watching the chat all the way through, obviously. So hang in there, people. It gets better. There's 3 of them. You've seen the first one. That was done when I had no clue what I was doing and no experience in any of it. So the 2 and 3 are longer, and hopefully you'll think they're better.
I think, well, for one thing, part two is in widescreen, since 16:9, so that's a
look at me, eh?
You're getting real now. You will notice as the series goes on, like the animations, especially I've noticed like a lot of the freehand camera work in style in number 3. The lip syncing is also brilliant. I think you had someone do the lip syncing for 3-4, didn't you?
Yes, a lady I know called Samantha Geisman. She was big in on she's big on the series. She was in Eve. She helped with Eve Radio at some point.
Right.
And so I've had an interview with her and Spuffy, I believe he was called at the time. And that was one of the most fun podcasty type radio interviews I've ever done. It's fantastic. She wanted to help out. And I just said, God, if you could do the lip sync, and it's such a grind, you manually, syncing the lips, hence the term. But it's like per phoneme, so the kind of per syllable sort of thing. And the editor crashes all the time, and it's horrible.
Brilliant.
Story of these films' lives.
Yeah. Somebody asked me to do this in chat before, so I was just going to do it now. Could you guys, if this is the first time that you've ever watched Clear Skies in chat, could you just give us an X so we can get some idea of how many people are just being introduced to it now? Wow.
These are the ones that are still here after watching the first one. That's the impressive thing.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Wow.
All right, so for the rest of the stream, we're going to go straight into the second movie now. It's about 45 minutes. And then after that, we'll take a small 10-minute break, and then we will be diving into Clear Skies 3. All right, so keep hanging out in chat. Keep quoting the lines in advance just to flex a little bit. I've done it a few times myself. It always feels good. This is kind of like, this is the Rocky Horror of EVE Online.
We're quoting all the lines.
Yeah, everyone's quoting the lines, and I reckon if we actually do this like in a proper theater one day, maybe like an EVE Online event, there'll be people in cosplay and maybe throwing teddy bears at the screen when you mention Mr. Smith and stuff like that. We could actually, it could be a real thing. All right, we're going to dip into the second movie now, guys. So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
I know, Sol.
I'm just saying, it's been a while since we've had a good contract.
I know, Sol.
The last few weren't up to much, what with the war going on.
I'm aware of that.
So just be nice to this guy, no matter what you think. Can you do that?
Of course I can. Shouldn't you be fixing a docking computer or something?
I'm just saying, we need the money. Be nice. John, I said be nice. Talk to him.
Go away.
Mr. Rourke, I assure you that this will be worth your while. Although, may I suggest we retire to a safer part of the ship?
What do you mean, safer? Why?
Because I was followed.
Seal ship, code blue,
meet me in the cargo bay.
Code blue? Code red, code orange, code yellow. Ah, here it is, code blue. Armed incursion of the ship? I don't suppose I could interest you in a jelly baby?
Good job, someone knows what code blue means.
Well, you wrote them. And 15 of them, I might add. I dread to think what Code Magnolia means.
Yeah, you should see Code Fuchsia.
Where's my gun? What have I done with it? Have you seen my gun?
I don't know where your gun is. Perhaps we could move along.
Right. Yeah, of course not. Yeah, I mean, you brought all the other guns with
you. They are cutting through the door, Mr. Rourke.
Ah, kitchen, the kitchen. Right, follow me. You're paying for that. And that. Oh, I really like that.
You will be fully compensated. Should we emerge from this alive?
Nah. I just thought something that might help there. Cover me!
Me cover you? I'm sure there's gunnery things going on here. Remind me who does that.
One shot off. Move up.
Oh, that's not good.
Huh?
Now I remember why you're gunnery.
Well done of the big explodey thing.
Explodey thing? It's got a proper name, you know. It's a kinetic... Oh, very funny.
May I suggest we undock with haste? There are probably more on their way to us now.
They look unfriendly.
Yeah, that battleship's locked us up. And oh look, we're jammed.
Ah yes, another blackbird. Are they free with cereal now or something?
I see you, this got my security team. Bravo.
The plucky independent crew survive another scrape. I've read up on you, Rourke, but your usual blind luck and all reliance on your wayward friends won't... What are you trying to dock with me?
Oh, yeah, sorry about that. So, docking computer's playing up again.
Okay, hang on, I'll hit it.
Your shoddy Minmatar equipment is the least of your problems.
Yeah, hold on a second. So?
Yeah?
While you're at it, fire up the sensor boosters.
Sensor boosters?
And Charlie?
Hit that blackbird as soon as you get locked, there's a good chap.
Love to. Nobody likes an e-warfare ship.
What do you think?
Two things I've learned lately. One, don't get jammed.
Sir, their weapon systems are back online.
And two...
What?
Stationary ships don't react well to 1400s.
Get us out of here!
I'm sorry, did he just run away from us?
I do believe he did. Someone marked the calendar.
Are we sure something scarier than us didn't just undock as well?
Well, I thought that, but there's no shuttles on scan.
When you've quite finished, get us into warp somewhere, so... Right, you. It's time we had a chat. Your cool exterior's starting to get on my implants, Smith. So how about filling me in on exactly what the hell is going on?
I really don't think this is the time or place to discuss this.
Oh, I think it's the perfect time and place.
Very well. I am an agent of certain interested parties that are rather against the waste of resources that the current political situation represents.
So you mean your black ops, then? And by political situation, you mean Caldari and Galente killing each other again?
Indeed. My superiors could see relations turning sour some time ago, so they mobilised several plans to help prepare for the coming storm.
One of those plans was to set up a privateer fleet as a deniable one-use-only asset for the future, should it ever be required.
How do you ever expect to make a fleet out of privateers? Privateer means independent. Do you want me to look that word up for you?
We use large amounts of money, Mr. Burke. The captains involved are out and about, plying their merry trade as we speak. But what with the amount offered, and certain penalty clauses, we would expect around 90% of them to form up when required.
Sounds optimistic, even if you're buying their loyalty. You can count us out.
Ah, Mr. Fodder, we didn't just choose anyone. Myself and other agents chartered the crew and tested them for suitability.
Tested them? Tested them? Are you telling me what happened the first time we met was staged by you? That is it. You're going back in the airlock.
Oh, no, no, please, Mr. Rourke. Heavens, our tests are a lot less severe. No, I had incurred the wrath of my opposites by being far too adept at my profession, and you just happened to be there when they caught up with me. How very fortunate you are here once again when I am in need.
Fortunate is not the word I'd use about getting my cargo base shot up. You're bad news. And who the hell were they anyway?
The answer to that lies with an agent of mine who has had their cover, and subsequently my own, blown as it were. Clearly they have uncovered something of note, so I am here because I need you to recover said agent.
Sounds messy. It'll cost you.
I am willing to pay, so it is a deal then.
Lads?
Sure, sounds like fun.
Yeah, we need the cash.
Yep, it's a deal. What station they at?
Station?
How was I supposed to know it'd be planetside? I was expecting a cargo ship interception or something.
He said an old prison facility.
Distract the escort, threaten the pilot, in and out in moments, that sort of thing.
What do we know about breaking into a prison facility?
Well, actually lads, might have an idea or two.
Looking good there, Sol.
I feel ridiculous. Where did you get this? The one size fits no one shop.
They're a souvenir from an old job.
You and your shadowy past fodder. Ew, did you wash them?
They are a bit second hand, I admit.
So, these and that dodgy security key you've got are going to get us in, are they?
It's an old facility on a backwater planet. Not exactly maximum security, and I know how they operate. Get your suit on and we'll shuttle down.
The admin block's over there. Let's go.
My suit itches.
Mine's painfully tight around my bot. Hang on. What's this stain? Is this blood? This is blood, isn't it? Great. Someone's blood's on my suit.
I did say they were second hand. Now shut up and let me do the talking. Yeah, I'm here for the 111D on Sasha Colhane. The Peter F details are in that key I forwarded to you. Get the prisoner out here quick, will you? I've got a 224 to be getting to. You know how it is.
Jared said he'd be sending someone over. Didn't realise it'd be this quick.
He did? Yeah, he did. Well, of course, we don't like to keep Jared waiting, do we?
No, we don't.
Excellent.
Hold on. Something's come back on this key.
Probably just a typo. Right, we'll be off then.
Hang on. This isn't right. This is out of date.
Well, I've been out in pirate space. I've only just got back. I might be out of the loop a bit.
Out of date? By 2 years?
Okay, that's very out of the loop. Hey, it was a long mission. Suddenly I get this call off of James.
Jared,
come here, do a 111D, blah, blah. You know what they're like. It's chaos out there. Oh, forget it. Plan B!
So this is Plan B, then, is it? Another gunfight, for the love of God!
Shut up and get the shuttle started.
Let me do talking, he said. I know how they operate, he says. Get us back up to clear skies, sharpish soul. There we go. One unit of damsel in distress.
Who said that? Who said that? Was that you? Do I look like a damsel in distress? I was distressed by your rescue attempt, I'll tell you that. Am I rescued or do we just crash into a scrapyard?
Hey, whoa, leave my ship alone.
I wish I could.
Oh, well, there's the door. Knock yourself out.
How about I knock you out for getting me shot at, huh?
Now, Sasha, there's no time for socialising, I'm afraid.
Where did you dig this up from, Tarquin?
Hey, we just saved... Tarquin?
Perhaps we could retire to somewhere more suited to debriefing.
Tarquin Smith?
Yes, and somewhere more suitable to take a shower as well. I mean, if there are showers, it doesn't look promising in this dump.
Can we give her back?
They're not exactly going to give her back, are they? Shall I put an advert in the Scoop? Wanted? Spy who is investigating our top secret plans to disrupt a peace conference. Misplaced by idiot. Reward offered.
You did say someone would be coming.
I didn't say hand them over to the first people you see, did I, you cretin?
They had papers.
They were so old, they may as well have handed over stone tablets. How much did she know about our operation? Well?
Sort of all of it, sir.
Outstanding. Well done on letting that go. Consider yourself fueling Poz Towers for the next 6 months. It's people like you that let the Caldari get anywhere in the first place.
Tarquin?
Tarquin.
Can we please proceed? Sasha?
Do you remember the Malkalin incident?
Oh, that's when Noir parked his mothership into the station in some sort of protest. Killed himself, thousands of others, and pretty much kicked off the Empire Wars.
The unprovoked invasion of Luminaire by Tiber's Heth caused the war. This was just, well, a reaction to the situation.
Kind of an extreme one.
As extreme as this man. I've been undercover watching Jared Mason.
Hey, who's the guy chasing Smith?
He's also the head of a covert movement within the Galente military, and the latest in lunatics with a similar idea to Noir.
A Galente acting like a nutter? Who'd have thought?
Don't let the actions of a few cloud your judgment.
Oh, of course not. Just because 95% of them are mad doesn't mean the rest are.
Typical Caldari response. Don't forget who invaded who.
Hey, up yours, missus. I'm on no one's side but my own here. Stop making out like it's all my fault somehow. I'm not interested.
It's attitudes like that which caused this war. Don't be so blinkered. How would
Please,
you like it if...
this is unproductive. Bicker after the debrief if you must.
Yes, well, the majority of Galente, as hard as this may be for some to believe, are trying to move towards a peace process and have been for some time. Thanks to them, the Caldari are receptive and are hosting talks in the system of Teskinen.
And Jared is against these talks?
Very much so. His movement, pure Galente, despised the Caldari for splitting off from the Federation in the past. They see this war as an opportunity to knock the Caldari back for a long time and reassert the dominance of the Galente race above its so-called breakaway fraction. He regards anyone trying to stop the war as traitors.
So is he actually a threat, or just a care bear who stared at an asteroid for too long?
Oh, he is a threat, Mr. Burke. Pure Galente is the most powerful underground group within their military structure.
Which gives them access to a mothership.
So he'll nick one and crash it into the station where the talks are?
That is the only logical conclusion.
The peace conference is scheduled to take place tomorrow. The delegates will already be there. We need to act now.
Indeed, Sasha. Mr. Rourke, it seems I have need of your courier services once more. I need to get to the system of Del Tol in order to coordinate a response to the situation. It's only about 10 jumps through Empire space.
Double fee!
Okay, I've got this. Big old capital ships can't use stargates, so they use jump drives, right?
Yes.
And jump drives need a
sinusoidal field.
That's the one. Created in a system they want to jump into.
Aye.
And you can jam them.
Yep.
So just send a warning, tell them to turn the jammer on. Problem solved. Home in time for tea and crumpets. I tell you, I'm wasted here.
Funnily enough, someone else thought of all that, but the big flaw in your master plan is that the comms to the system are run through the fleet guarding the in-gate. They get to decide what's important and what isn't.
And they're Galente?
Yes, and if they're in on Jared's plan, the message will never get there and he'll know Smith is onto him.
So send an interceptor or one of those cloaker weirdos through?
I think that's the plan.
Wait,
why are we veering left?
The computer's trying to dock with that freighter over there.
My sofa would do a better job than that thing.
Docking request accepted.
If Smith runs this place, you'd think he could afford a couple of different suits. You know, a bit of variety.
Yeah, well, let's just get our cash and...
Well, this is most troubling. It seems the delegation required the ability to jump their support ships, so they didn't provide a sinusoidal field jammer.
That was good planning. How much are these people paid again?
Regardless of that, there is now an urgent need for one to be delivered.
Good luck with that.
It just so happens, Mr. Burke, that there is a ship in this station with a large enough cargo hold to fit the equipment in.
Before you go any further, I seem to recall that this was just a transport job, and to my amazement, we got here intact. So that's our business concluded, thanks. We've got no reason at all to get our asses shot off in some military op.
I can give you many reasons. Observe.
Who are they?
These are all the people that would die in the attack. That is a normal, populated station.
Kaldari, Galente, Minmitar, Amarian, young, old, no front lines here, no borders, no boundaries.
So how long is that list?
About 100,000. They'll be dead from the attack before you could read it all.
It's still not our fight.
Not even stations are safe anymore. It's everybody's fight.
It's time to pick a side, Mr. Rourke.
Why us?
That's what I'd like to know.
We have little time, and you are here with the right ship for the job. After witnessing your performance under extreme circumstances, I am quite confident of a reasonably high chance of success.
Still not convinced.
And if there was any act that would ease your conscience about the raid on the Navy base all those years ago, then this would be it.
And what would you know about that?
Only that the dock bay doors wouldn't open because of the alarm, and Mr. Haffer, trapped in his freshly stolen ship, was very insistent that you shoot them open from the outside, but he failed to mention the tour shuttle directly behind those doors, and the families on board that.
All right, that's enough. You've made your point.
Your chance to exercise some personal demons, then. You will not be going in alone. I have already put the call out to mobilise the Phantom Fleet. They will have but one job, to get you through that gate. We also have some upgrades for your ship to somewhat enhance its resilience.
JR, a word. You aren't seriously thinking of doing this, are you?
Well, it seems to me
Do you know what you're talking about here? Fly through an enemy fleet, voluntarily. And if we survive that, put ourselves in the way of a capital ship that's got a brick on the accelerator. This has gone far beyond just shifting Smith around. What the hell's wrong with you?
100,000 people could die.
Making it 100,000 free isn't going to help, is it? Don't get me wrong, I want to help. This sounds like suicide.
Ah, come on, Sol. We'll have the Phantom Fleet covering us. We sneak through the gate, drop off the jammer and go back to our normal life with a load of cash and an upgraded ship. How hard can it be?
Sneak? Sneak through? I don't even know where to start with what you just said. Are you really that daft?
Yeah. Yes, he is.
I know. I don't know why I asked.
Look, I can't live with myself if I walk away from this. I've got to try and help, no matter how it turns out, and I've got my reasons. If you guys don't want to come along, I'll understand.
Miss a gate fight? A real gate fight with a real fleet? Not a chance. Haven't been in one of those for years.
Oh, well, you're a lot of help. Voice of reason right there.
Says the voice of reason that let Smith on board in the first place.
Oh, yes. So I did. Fine. Well, if you excuse me, I've got somewhere else to be.
Ah, come on, Solly, didn't mean it.
You won't get through that enemy fleet with your combined skills of pressing the fire button and staring moodily out of the window. I'm not leaving. I'm here to the end. You know that. I'm just going to go and get a mirror so I can properly kiss my ass goodbye.
Magnificent, isn't it? Where did we acquire this from?
An old fight with the Amarians, it seems, several years ago.
The things you find left lying around. People are so careless. And it's Amarian. Perfect. Nobody likes the Amarians. They get the blame for everything.
Yes, well, there'd be good salvage from that. I'm glad somebody's finally making use of it. It's been cluttering up this dock for years. We've removed all the fittings and the armour plate already, and the structure is weak, but...
It does still fly, doesn't it? I'd be very upset if it doesn't.
Yes, yes, the engines and shield emitters are still installed, but do please take care. See, the structure's very badly damaged
it
and...
It won't have to go far. Not far at all.
How's Smith's boys doing?
I wish I knew. Half the stuff I've never seen before, and I'm sure most of the crates are marked top secret.
Top secret duct tape?
Might as well be. They're making modifications to bits of the ship I never even knew existed. Mind you, have a look at the shields.
92% thermal resistance? Is that a typo?
The modifications to your vessel proceed apace. The fleet is forming up around the sun in Varalan, so meet them there. Our presence here is no longer required, so I wish you good fortunes in your endeavours.
How did it ever get to all this?
These are the difficult times I spoke of.
Yeah, thanks for the Zen, Tarquin.
Must you persist in using that form of address?
Possibly I use it, because that is your name.
Good luck, John.
Docking permission requested.
Don't redock! Don't redock, what are you doing?
Great, they fit a billion quid's worth of stuff to the ship, but they don't fix the docking computer.
Is now a good time to mention the light-up of my console?
So that's pretty much the situation, Half. Are you in?
You must be joking.
What?
I've got better things to do with my life than end it early.
Oh, well, I suppose you never did care much about people on a station as long as you got your shiny toy.
Oh, spare me the lecture.
You're happy to do a suicide run for people you don't know, but I get you to do me one small favour and you go on about it for years.
Small favour? There's a line you just don't cross and you leapt over it that day. I mean,
and how many times have you benefited from this guilt-ridden ship? I tell you what, you don't like it, don't use it.
100,000 people at risk and you give me this. You know, I've always wondered, how do you sleep at night? Guess it's just us then.
So what Smith said, is it true? About the raid? We've all got our history, John.
Yeah, you were trying to save people, Sol. I was just stealing something.
Space is a dangerous place. You didn't know they were there, so... What are you looking at?
Just... Mothership blueprints in a vain hope that everyone else in the universe has missed a weak spot.
I doubt it. Redundant bridges, triple backups on all systems, hardened antimatter storage. My word, that's over-engineered.
I know. Short sticking a doomsday device up its backside, I think the only way to kill one quickly is to ram it with a station, but that's just getting silly.
We're at the rendezvous point. The fleet commander's hailing us. And it's Shady.
Excuse me?
Shady Slater.
You know this guy?
Hello, Fodder.
Thought I could smell you.
Hello, mate.
Haven't seen you since we turned those mineral thieves inside out all those years ago. Still independent of the big boys, then?
Yeah, until about 5 minutes ago.
They dragged me away from a fat crocite asteroid. Just got settled in mining it and all this breaks loose, so I have to leg it over here to run the show.
You're in charge? How'd that happen? You didn't volunteer, did you?
I don't know. I got offered money and lost my sense of perspective, I think. Either that or everyone else took one step back.
Oh, well, that's reassuring, you being in charge. If it was a mining op, I'd understand, but this?
Tell me about it. Anyway, less of your cheek or I'll call your ship primary target by accident. Get your heap aligned to the Teskanen gate. We should have been there ages ago.
How big is the fleet at the gate?
Well, it's not small. Fleet, Shady here.
I do speeches about as well as I do fighting, you lucky people. So I'll just say, you're getting paid a lot for this. You only have to work together once, and the better you do, the more chance you have of coming out of it rich and alive. And knowing you lot, that's in order of priority.
They're in system. Arrival is imminent, and the fleet composition is poor.
They'll not win this fight.
We have one job, and that's to get JR's lump of scaffolding through the gate.
Be ready to focus fire on any suspicious activity. Pay attention to the primary and secondary target calls.
Once that's done, we disperse and never speak of this again. Easy enough for even me to work out, so you lot should be able to.
Stand by, Heavy Interdictor. I want them forced out of warp at optimal range.
I imagine they know we're here by now.
So start hoping it's the ship next to you that gets blown up, and not yours.
Well, that was inspiring. So, what are our chances then?
Oh, normally I'd lie to you and say it'd be alright. But this time though, I don't know.
It's a good job we're not on our own then. I'd better head down and pull the safeties. Still, warping to a gateway you know for sure there's going to be a fight, kind of makes the blood sing even after all these years.
Warp drive active.
Interdictor!
Oh great, we're 40k off the gate. It'll take 4 minutes to get there. We're in trouble. Stand this for long enough, we aren't going to make it.
Time for one last surprise from Mr. Smith then.
A motor warp drive? In a battleship? Are you insane? They aren't built for this.
Go on, my son.
We're still getting a right coil shooing, just about four seals let go.
Stop him reaching the gate. Is anyone in range of that tackler? It's gonna whip him.
It's got us. We've got seconds before the shields go. Are we in range?
No, we didn't make it.
you and Tacklers, John. I swear, you get jammed more often than the Jeep at Stargate. What are you doing here? Saving your arse, again. Besides, I never did say how I slept at night. Badly.
He's done it, John! We're moving again!
Destroy that widow!
We've taken this far as well. They're attacking Haffa. That's bought us some time.
Bug out, Haff. You've done it. Now go!
Well then, shoot at me. I don't shoot at you. Save the station, John.
Haff, we will. Now go. Jump out.
He's got no tank, JR. He's falling to bits.
Now are we even?
Yes.
Captain John Rourke of the Clear Skies, broadcasting on Caldari Emergency Channel
Oscar Mike Foxtrot Golf.
We have urgent information regarding the safety of the delegation at the station. Please accept and authenticate this pre-recorded message packet.
Sir, the message checks out. It's official.
This is serious business, Captain Rourke. I understand you have a cyno-jammer with you?
Yes, sir. We need to get it deployed.
Sir, a sinosaural field has been detected in close proximity to the station.
Wing 1 and 2, with me, the rest of you stay on gate. Ensign, warp us to that sino.
Yes, sir.
Comms, open a channel to the station, priority 1. They need to start evac.
Station, begin immediate evacuation of all personnel. I say again, begin immediate evacuation of all personnel.
Understood, Fleet. Evacuation alarm set and militia mobilising. Estimate 3 0 minutes for 85%. Repeat, 3 0 minutes for 85% evac.
That jammer is no use now with the signal already up. We're too late.
After all this, we're too late.
We still might be able to stop it.
Get to your optimals, load heavy ammunition.
What in Divinity's Edge?
That's not a mothership, that's a Titan!
Avatar class Titan, super capital of Amarian origin, 250K shielding.
Armor class, 350K. Locking on, what's the DPS?
Trajectory 175, Mark 4. Calculating transverse and fall off now.
Get us into firing range, now.
Existing structural damage detected. No armor installed.
It's a junker. No fittings, no armor plating, and the structure's falling to bits. Once up in the right placements, you will fall apart.
Shields are full, though. It'll take over 20 minutes to get through them. We're too damn late!
Jared Mason, this is Commander Malozzi of the Caldari Navy. I'm ordering you to stand down and shut off your engines.
Do you seriously expect that to happen? Now, after all my efforts...
Last time I saw you, all your effort was going into running away from me.
Ah, Rourke. You've been a headache to me, you know, but that is all. Observe. All your efforts have been futile, for I am here, and I will succeed in what I came to do.
Jared, there are innocent people on that station.
Innocent? No one here is innocent. No one. The Caldari brought this upon themselves, and anyone who sides with them dies with them.
Open fire!
Oh, bring it on, please!
Station, we aren't going to stop it in time. It's going to hit you.
We've only evacuated 3%. It'll take at least half an hour.
You've got just under 6 minutes. Save as many as you can.
Sir, the wings at the gate report that Galenti Defence Fleet is jumping through and engaging. They request our assistance urgently.
Fleet, prepare to disengage and walk back to the Viralin gate at optimal.
What? You're leaving? Just like that?
Sorry, John, but those people are lost to us now. There is nothing we can do against a Titan. We have to go back to stop those Galenti bastards, or they'll have a free fire on the evacuees.
It makes sense, JR. We should go help. We can't sit here and watch this when there's payback to be had.
You're right. Walk us to the gate, Sol. We may as well help there, seeing as we can't help this. What the hell was that?
Big problem here, JR. Core containment test let go. The modifications weakened it, and it took too much for kicking getting us through that gate.
Well, get it fixed sharpish. We need it back there.
No, John, you don't understand. This one's beyond fixing.
What do you mean, beyond fixing?
I'm saying that engineering's about to be filled with hard radiation, and then the core is going to go up and take the rest of the ship and anything nearby with it. That's it. She's done. We need to leave right now.
One tap in the right place, eh, Solomon? Okay. All crew, all crew. Abandon ship, abandon ship.
When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band.
It's all going to plan.
Would you be
staying to watch the show, John?
How long have we got?
About 3 minutes. Hey! What the bloody hell are you doing?
You promised me 3 minutes, old friend.
And now to watch those traitors die.
From a safe distance, of course.
I don't know what you're trying to do, Johnny boy, but you're too late, too late.
Well, old girl, one last flight. Docking into the mouth of hell. Docking?
Where is he going? I think he's going for the hydrogen tanks behind the engine.
Come on, come on, you limitar! Don't pick now of all times to work properly!
Walking permission requested.
Yes!
That stuff's stable.
Not when a warp core goes up near it. Oh my word!
How big a bang's that gonna make?
How fast can this pod go?
The hydrazine tanks? No. No.
Station reports that the Titan has been destroyed.
Rock, you've met a real enemy now! I'll burn everyone you ever met! I'll... What the... Well, that was... No. No! No!
This is Rescue Vessel Calypso. Please respond. This is Rescue Vessel Calypso. Please respond. Over. This is Rescue Vessel Calypso. Please respond. John Rourke. This is Rescue Vessel Calypso. Please respond. Over. Sorry, sir. We're getting nothing.
Let me try. John, I know you're out there. I know you can hear me. You're pressing the wrong button again, aren't you? I told you it's the other one. The label's wrong.
Oh, right. That explains that. Can you hurry up? It's cold and I've banged my knee.
Hey,
I believe we have helped the peace process along a great deal, Mr. Rourke. And that means my job in this region is done. You'll no doubt be pleased to hear.
Doesn't really matter now, Mr. Smith. With no ship, I guess this chapter in my life is over.
Is that it, then?
No more adventures?
Well, not even space stations are safe now, and I've gone up the arse of a Titan one too many times for my comfort, thanks. Nope, that's it. I'm retiring from space.
You, planet side.
I'll give it 6 months before you're back up here, tops. It's in your blood, John.
Tell you what, when the Minmatar make a battleship that's actually finished, then I'll come back.
Well, in that case, look out the window.
Ho ho ho, what is that?
That, my dear chap, is a Maelstrom battleship. What the Minmatar can design and build where they aren't trying to escape slavery at the same time.
They even attach the top wingy bit properly.
How much does that cost?
To us, nothing. It's a thank you gift from Mr. Smith. But as you're retiring, I guess we can sell
what
it.
What idiot said anything about retiring? Why would I retire? That's crazy talk, man. There's a whole universe out there, you know, full of adventure.
Mr. Rourke.
More like 6 seconds and 6 months.
Mr. Rourke.
Is it fitted? Can we undock?
John. I do hope you're going to insure it this time.
Oh, well, yeah, of course. Hey, you! How much is it to insure that?
What, Maelstrom Battleship?
Yeah.
About 30 million isk, sir.
How much?
It is. Get over there and scoop it up, quick. Oh, yes.
Sorry, I forgot about that bit. Sorry, friends. Jumped in a little bit too early on the transition. And we're back from that one. Man, Ian, I'm not gonna lie, the last sort of third of that movie is pretty bit of a ride, you know? Like, you get some feels on more than one occasion.
It's pretty intense. I saw like they grew up a bit. And each time I did the film, I don't know, it got a bit more serious, a bit darker, maybe in places. Not so much 1 to 2, perhaps, but the third certainly does it.
Well, it feels to me like there's more humour in part two, but the humour occurs more frequently, I would say, than even in part one. But you're right, the heavy parts in part two are certainly much more pronounced, and I think that pulls it in that direction.
I was surprised by the effect that the death of Haffa had on people. It kind of shows that the writing and the characters must have been there for people to get so attached that losing him generates what I saw in the chat while it was on. I mean, that was fantastic for me to see the effect it has. You know, it's really rewarding after all that work that people are loving it so much.
And you managed to get people into that place after like a 36 minute video, which featured Haffer in the first one for all of what, like 6 or 7 minutes as well.
But yeah,
and I think that makes your point about like the story was in the right spot, because that the interaction he has with JR in the first movie, and the, you know, like, are we even yet, you know, kind of it says volumes about a personal history that they share without you needing to necessarily talk about it. But it just creates that weight in the room.
Yeah, the first one I did is like a pilot, TV show pilot style thing. Obviously, it wasn't literally a pilot for TV, but it's like 40 minutes. You've got to introduce the characters, introduce the universe, and set up some plot threads. So there's a lot of stuff in one which never really got explained, like, you know, the history with Haffer and who these people are and why Sol, what happened to Sol in the Navy and all that business. So that actually gave me a lot of things to play with writing the scripts for 2 and 3. Some things never actually got resolved, but some things did. So yeah, there was a lot of good stuff to tap into on one. And I saw some of the comments in the chat streaming up now. It's like they said that, like, it's like I find my feet with the second one. And I think I agree. I always like to do things bigger and better. There's no point doing the same thing again, I feel. And I don't mean just bigger explosions, saying that I blew up a Titan, doesn't get much bigger. But, you know, when it came to the third one, I couldn't blow up a station or a planet or get it, because it got ridiculous. And so it got more focused down to the conflict between JR and the protagonist. So, you know, things matured along that front, and I tried some stuff and some things worked and some things didn't. And I do know that, but you have to push yourself as a writer and a director and just, well, general dog's body doing pretty much everything. So the things just got bigger each time in terms of what I could do, and part of the, well, what I could do in 3 was thanks to the generosity of CCP loaning me out the Jessica engine. So that's all good stuff to come.
Yes, yeah, so I was going to ask you about that, because you're still basically frapsing in-game footage that you've had to coordinate with other players and things like that for these scenes. That's correct?
Yeah, the 1 and 2, it was just frapsing stuff. 2 were, because of the success of 1, it meant I had access to a lot of volunteers.
Right.
And then I had a fleet wrangler, and then it all had to be done like one specific time, one weekend, where 40 odd people got together with all their, and of course they brought all their best ships
because
they wanted to look good on camera.
Was that on the main server?
It was done in, is it Singularity, the test one?
I was going to say, because I know, up Macarials and stuff, and in 2009, Macarials were not cheap.
We blew up a Titan, mate.
It's like, yeah, people sorry. Go,
how much money did you spend on those ships? It's like peanuts compared to what's coming up.
Actually,
you know.
And now I think about it, even if the community loved Clear Skies 1, you wouldn't have been able to get enough clear space just to get what you wanted done on Tranquility anyway, because people would always be showing up just to screw around.
Yeah, it just wouldn't have worked, really. It was super, super secret. It was a testament to the stunt pilots involved and the guy who wrangled the fleet for me, that everything really worked. And the best thing was, because we didn't want to do any spoilers, everyone knew that the what's that ship called, the Haffer's ship? Oh, this is embarrassing. Someone in chat, tell me. Widow, thank you. Everybody knew the Widow was Haffer's ship, so yes, thank you. I've read it now, you can stop. Everybody knew that was his ship. So if I had it blow up, that's like a major spoiler. So we had one guy in the stunt pilot fleet who was in on it. And no one else knew apart from me, the fleet wrangler guy, and this one guy. And this one guy's job was, at this precise moment, to blow up half a ship. And then we ripped hell into him in the chat.
Oh, you make it look like...
You effing idiot. What have you done? We've got to go and get another... We even had the guy go back and get another Widow from the station and bring it back to carry on filming. No one knew that was actually the shot. of him dying. You know, it was genuine, and that really worked. No one had a clue that that was coming.
That's absolutely brilliant. So, something else that jumped out at me while I was watching that I've watched these movies plenty of times, but like it never really landed on me until I was watching all the comments and chat. When the scene where you see the old character portraits, going, you know, the would-be victims of the attack, and it even happened in the first movie too when the widow showed up and it was the old Scorpion hull and you've got the old models and the old skyboxes. I mean, you personally might sometimes feel like these videos may be a little bit clunky and you can say, yeah, that was a product of the time. But you know what? There's actually something really, really valuable about having this snapshot of Eve as it was at the time. Because current players, newer players can look back and see how far we've come. And, you know, veteran players can sort of just sort of look at it and feel the wave of nostalgia all over them. It's really, really awesome.
Yeah, it's funny seeing. Someone said I'm a bit loud still, so I've moved my mic boom slightly away from my face. So okay. Hopefully that's better. And I kind of get overexcited and get loud. So, yeah, it's fun seeing all the old stuff. I mean, the big joke about cleaning the windows in the first Clear Skies was because you had the old engine. And with like the really square bridge, and I'd built the set and everything, and then like 2 months into my production, and I'd already filmed a bunch of scenes. You buggers went and changed
Trinity.
Your entire graphics engine.
Yeah, you have to.
So I had to cut and shut job on the front of the bridge to make it the more three sided nose of the Tempest, and then reshoot everything. So I did that whole bit of JR saying, oh, everything looks really different, was a bit of a nod towards the effort I had to put in there.
As always.
Oh, and there's a million
and
things I could talk
that
about.
That opening credit sequence, too, on that one was incredibly mad. Yeah, you did, really. Did you, like, sort of finish the project and be like, oh, I'm going to go back and spruce this up, or was that the plan all the time? Did you not do it in the first one because you just hadn't quite developed as much at that point?
Oh, the first one was just about getting it done.
Yeah.
You know, do what I could. The second one was like, well, I kind of know a workflow now of how to do all this stuff. And I didn't do much different apart from put it in widescreen and just push what I could do with the engine and the tools that I already knew. So I worked out that I could have this cool thing where text appeared and disappeared. All that was done in-game. That was done in the Half-Life 2 engine, all the text appearing and disappearing. It wasn't done in post-production in the editor. So there's some really shonky stuff going on behind the scenes to achieve that. Even just recording the exact same footage twice, but one's got the text there, one hasn't, which is how it disappears as soon as it goes behind someone. You know,
so you're saying you didn't like mask the models or anything like that? No. Push off the wall? No, nothing that sophisticated. No. Well, if you think that's shonky, you should see how we make EVE Online.
So I've heard.
All right, well let's take a 9 minute and 38 second break now, because that's how long the two songs that I have queued up are. When we come back, we're going to spin up Clear Skies 3. You guys will be able to see the next evolution. If you thought the jump between 1 and 2 was dramatic, this is absolutely going to blow your mind. It's also as long as both the first movies combined. It's actually a true space opera epic, and it's an excellent add-on to the story. So go refuel your drinks, go grab a quaife or you know, pet the cat, or whatever it is you need to do, have a bio, and come back in about 9.5 minutes, and we'll get into Clear Skies 3. All right, folks, we're back. I hope you managed to get whatever it was you needed to get done while we're on that short little break. In just a minute here, we're going to jump into Clear Skies 3 to round out this marathon. Before we go into that, though, I was going to just quickly ask Ian a question, because this came up in chat. All the music that I've played tonight in the stream, in the lead up and during the breaks and so forth, are all songs which I took directly from the soundtrack for the Clear Skies series. And I have to say, like, you've done a great job working in a lot of like traditional EVE Online music, like by Jon Heller and stuff like that. But you've picked, which at the time I'm sure were just contemporary songs that you loved, but are still incredibly appropriate. How much thought, for, well, it's not the right word, how closely did you try to pick music that would associate and be appropriate to what was happening in the series?
It's a question I get asked a lot, actually. People seem to like the fact that the music matches the action an awful lot. And the actual answer to it is that the music led some of the scenes. For example, like I used to be on the bus going to and from work, bored out of my head, and I'd be listening to an MP3 player, if you remember those, back in the day, and I would get the Tubular Bells 3 finale and think, God, this would be good to do a fleet battle for.
Yeah.
And then I'd think of the story beats based around what you were hearing in the song. And like, so that scene was actually written for the music. It wasn't the other way around, really.
Did you see there in chat, Manea Ice-Eshin said, you led me to Mike Oldfield.
Yeah, I'm a mega fan of his. And the thing is you need atmospheric music. And he writes. He's such a diverse musician. He's fantastic. And he writes any style, and he writes it well. So an awful lot of his music does crop up simply because it fits. The only one I haven't used is Tubular Bells itself because it's too cliche.
Yeah, no. I was going to say, it's very well known. And Dallas Black also says you're responsible for him to getting into Mike Oldfield. So, I mean...
And Waffly Heart as well.
As much as making the video is great for the Eve players, this is like these ancillary kind of... benefits, the things that you've brought to people by making.
Yeah, I think the fact that I haven't ever tried to make like money off it, really, because it's just written for the fans, you know,
of course.
That's why it hasn't been taken down on YouTube or anything, because no, I've got no licenses for music. Of course I haven't.
Yeah.
It costs millions or something. But I think like they've actually, the artists to some degree have probably made some money. I don't know if people have gone out and paid for Mike Oldfield's stuff. That's got to be a win for him. It's not like I'm stealing cash from him. I do remember going to the whole Far Above the Clouds YouTube clip, and it's just taken over by the Eve Nutters quoting lines, and other people are like, who are you, and what the hell are you talking about?
That's absolutely brilliant.
So that's really cool.
The knock-on effect, like it's leaving its fingerprints all over that now. You've obviously led a lot of people to certain musical artists, so I'm pretty sure you're in credit there, mate.
Yeah, I've got a pretty eclectic taste in music, to be honest, which is great for digging up things for, like, you've got atmospheric, you've got high-energy things, just stuff that seems to fit the mood. Sometimes it can be a struggle to find it, and like I said, sometimes the music's actually leading the way.
Yeah. All right. On that note, we're now going to dive into Clear Skies 3. The finale to the trilogy, the biggest and most ambitious film that Ian made. At the conclusion of the film, we'll come back again and we'll have a bit of a Q&A with Ian. I will do my best to pluck out some questions from Twitch chat at the time, which I'm sure is going to be very frenetic and scrolling past very quickly. It might get a little bit untidy. We'll see how it goes, but we'll do our best to make it work. So make sure you stick around for that. And here we go with Clear Skies 3.
Sunbird, this is Nightstar. Come in, over.
Sunbird here, go ahead.
We have found your prize.
Are you sure? Does it match the signature?
Yes, much to our surprise. I thought this thing was vaporware, but hey, it was your money. So we checked what feels like half the known universe.
Yes.
But where is it?
Would you believe in the station?
You mean someone already has it?
For now.
You have a large budget, Ghost. Can I trust that you'll take care of these matters?
Already in hand. It's certainly costly, though. I had to spend real money to dig up the name involved, and then even more covering our tracks once I found out who it was.
Are we taking a risk?
Always a risk, Fallon. That's our business. Now, this geezer's a heavy hitter, no doubt, but fortunate for us, he doesn't actually have possession of the item. He just supplied it.
So, who has got it?
In a couple of hours, if all goes to plan, we will. Until then, well, no one's special.
Maelstrom yet?
No.
But we can't keep calling it the Maelstrom.
I know.
I mean, it's embarrassing on the paperwork.
Aye.
And you keep having to say, I'm Captain John Rourke of this here ship, and then read out the hull number.
I'm working on it, okay?
You know, you can always call it Clear's.
No, I can't.
Okay, okay. I'm just saying, it's an option.
No, it isn't. It's not the same ship. It's not the same ship. Anyway, Sol, shouldn't you have been engineering?
There's nothing to do. It all works, all the time.
You sound almost disappointed.
Well, it's certainly a lot quieter here now. Testing station give us a load of work after what we did for them. The ship's insured, we're making money, and for once we're not spending it on repairs.
Well, there's a butt in there somewhere.
How about, but I haven't fired my new guns yet?
Oh, good grief, Charlie. I suppose it's too much to ask that one of us stays on station while we dock.
Why bother? It's dull around here. You know it and I know it. Safe job shifting stuff around a couple of jumps tops and no one goes near us because of our Titan killing rep.
I consider that to be a good thing. You'd rather we were getting holes knocked in us than spending all our money fixing the ship again.
I remember sometimes we knocked holes in other people's holes. That was fun. Ah, speaking of fun.
Tell him we're out.
John, I have a well-paid job for you.
We have heard that before.
What?
Nothing. Carry on.
I require part of your old ship back.
Really?
Yes, it is mine. I installed it. I need it back, and I'm willing to pay.
All right, keep your tie on. We can get it now if you're desperate.
Yes, yes, that would be excellent. Hand it over in Teskinen at these coordinates at this time. I'll have a ship pick it up.
This gear's working great, Ghost. They're buying it.
Good. One fruity power supply, hand-delivered by gullible morons to a place with no station or gate guns within half a light year. How's our man at the station, Drank?
He's waiting for them to dock as we speak.
Spot on.
Excellent. I'll see you there.
Smith sound a bit odd.
Yeah, probably bored. Like us.
We need all four stealth bombers to make it quick. Let them know they all get to play.
Sorry, lads. Nothing exciting is going to happen today.
Subject, John Rourke. Recent history, captain of Tempest-class Minmatar battleship Clear Skies. This ship was destroyed in the Teskinen incident. It was self-destructed by Captain Rourke in order to destroy an Avatar-class Titan set on collision course with Teskinen Station. Current status, residing in Teskinen system. Captain of Maelstrom-class Minmatar battleship, unnamed. Threat level, moderate. Known affiliate, Solomon Sol Burt. Engineer, served 23 years in Kaldari Navy. Threat level, low. Known affiliate, Charles Charlie Fodder. Gunnery. History, unknown. Threat level, high. Known affiliate, first name unknown, last name Smith, presumed alias. Possible Kaldari command operative. Supplier of power source designated FAL 01 to John Rourke. Threat level, extreme. Known affiliate, Sasha Culhane, agent of Smith. Threat level, high.
Suppose we better undock then.
Early for once.
That's what comes from having a working ship.
Don't say that. Clear Skies used to get us where we wanted.
And a lot of places we didn't.
Mostly that was JR.
May as well let Smith know we're here.
Mr. Rourke.
For once, you contact me. What could possibly warrant this occasion?
The fact that we're here early, for once.
And where would here be?
The rendezvous point in Teskinen. I've got the power generator you wanted.
What power generator?
The one off Clear Skies. You want it back? You only asked 2 minutes ago.
That still exists.
Yes.
That and all the other stuff you installed that somehow survived. We salvaged it. Why are we even discussing this?
I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this.
The equipment I gave you still exists.
Yes, and you want some of it back, don't you?
I want nothing of the kind, Mr. Rourke. That should all have been destroyed. It was imperative. Part of the deal. Do you realise exactly what...
Lads, maybe we should head back to the station, sort this out. We're in the arse end of nowhere, after all.
You fail to realise the magnitude of this situation. Stay there, I'm on my way.
What the hell was that all about?
I don't know, but can we please discuss this back in the station? Only I'm starting to get the heebie-jeebies, sitting out here all on our lonesome, when clearly something's up.
Will you relax? There's no one for a million miles in any direction. Who are they?
Well, it's not Smith.
Charles, one big fat target on a starboard bag.
Port.
Yeah, like I know. Stick a couple into them. Let them know we're not interested.
They're powering up the guns.
Well then, Drake. Time for the magic box.
Command override received.
What the hell?
The signal bus has just gone down. Seals have gone. Binders are offline.
Tracking's out.
Engines warp the lot. I've got nothing.
Offline. Tracking offline.
That ship can't do that. What the hell's going on?
Bombers, decloak and take on the bitch. Don't damage the cargo hold.
There's something else out. Bombs!
You're joking!
Do I look like I'm joking?
Hit the pod right now! Right what now! We're not stopping those with everything off! Strap in!
I was expecting to find you in a somewhat larger ship.
Nah, the fuel economy was crippling us. We downsized.
This is not a time for flippancy.
Well, maybe it's a time for straight talking then. Like, who exactly are this latest bunch of jokers you've dragged along in your wake, Smith?
I have not dragged anything anywhere. This mess is entirely your own creation.
Having been stuck in this system for the last year doing soft jobs, I find that highly doubtful. Even we can't upset anyone under those circumstances.
But you did store highly classified items in a Tatty station warehouse, and now you wonder why undesirable elements have come after them.
You didn't mention highly classified when you supplied them.
Correct, Mr. Rourke. They were classified.
What could be so special about a couple of ship modules?
Maybe they're stolen.
Maybe they're gold-plated.
Radioactive.
Radioactive and gold-plated.
And stolen.
Maybe they're Jovian. Actually, that's not as stupid as it sounds.
Ah, well...
It'd explain a lot, like how quickly all that gear fitted together and just worked.
That's really not the issue.
And why I didn't recognise any of it.
Wait, wait, Jovians, are you serious? I mean, they're a myth, right? Genetically modified freaks, light years ahead of us, hidden away in some distant region, that sort of thing. Come on, it's the stuff you scare kids with.
I've heard a few things in my time about them, and this all fits.
Aren't they supposed to be, like, scary powerful?
Yeah, they are. Sol's right, this does all fit. Why have you mixed us up with them, Smith?
Yeah, don't make me put you in the airlock.
Very well, I am a Jovian agent.
I thought you worked for Kaldari State.
Mr. Rourke, I have never mentioned who I actually work for. I'm sure now you understand why.
You don't look Jovian.
Of course not. Consider me a giver of gifts. For example, one race invents the jump drive, making capital ships a reality. Quite the advantage, I'm sure you'd agree. And suddenly, all the races make similar breakthroughs. I hear the Minmatar achieved theirs at a research station in the system of Heck.
Oh, did they?
Why interfere like this?
I have a simple brief. No one race can be allowed to gain an advantage sufficient enough to fight the other three and actually win.
Well, I don't know why you're fuming over this power plant, then. I've done half your job for you. Just hand over the blueprints to everyone else.
Half my job? That power plant is decades ahead of anything currently in use. You have released one of the most dangerous artifacts I know of into the hands of a complete unknown. I now have a staggering amount of damage control to perform. I expect a great personal risk when it isn't a tedious grind. I can't fathom the depths of ineptitude required to hand such an artifact over to the first person you met.
They looked and sounded like you. They certainly had a stuck-up attitude, right?
Perhaps a year of soft jobs in this system has significantly reduced your faculties as ship's captain.
Hey, they're sailing close to the solar wind, Smith.
Name me a recent situation where you didn't rely on the help of a friend to extract you, or perhaps the sacrifice of one.
You and I better go our separate ways. I see you again. You'll be the one needing friends.
I intend to. I have a busy time ahead rectifying your mistakes. See yourselves out when we dock.
Well, we've looked at this overpowered toaster and can't make sense of it, so it must be cutting edge, right?
Yes, and yet should work with the artifact.
Yeah, what is that thing?
An interesting question. We found it on an asteroid we were mining at the edge of known space. Ancient, but seemingly intact.
It took us a year to work out how to power it up.
Old and alien, huh? Must be worth a bit. What's it do?
Originally, we have no idea.
Oh, marvelous. So we can fire it up, but we lost the instruction manual.
What it used to do is not important. When powered up in the current state, this artifact seems to emit interspatial frequencies, equivalent to that of a fully functioning...
Excuse me?
Well, it will turn off stargates, if you give it enough power.
How the hell does it turn off gates?
Well, I was just explaining
that. Shut up, you... Why do you got such a buzz for turning off a gate?
Oh, not just a gate. All the gates in a system. All of them. Which means we can take our planet back. Get our home back. And no one will be able to take it away again. With their damn lies and their laws. And helping us with that is our next job for you.
Lucky me.
Lucky us. All this from a chance archaeological find.
Huh. I'm not a fan of archaeology. Things should stay buried.
Well, in your line of work, Ghost, I'm not surprised that that's your attitude.
Nice of Smith to drop us off in the middle of precisely nowhere. Good job you did there. You didn't upset me or anything.
You heard what he said.
Well, with the insurance money, we can get a cruiser.
Now, you know what? You know what? Forget it.
What?
Because the worst part of it is, he was right. All I do is blunder through life and bring death on my friends. I nearly got us all killed today. Again. I'm done.
Don't be daft.
No, I'm done, Sol. I should have given this up the last time. Seems I only learn when it's too late.
Where in the world did you go? Without a crew, without a word. What on earth did I do wrong? You won't believe how much I hurt. I can't believe the mess we're in. My sense of humor wearing thin gets away with murder every day. Can't you hear me? Won't you make it go?
What do you want?
Haven't seen you for a month, and that's the greeting I get.
Shove it, Sol, I'm busy.
Busy finding the bottom of a bottle. As an engineer, I can assure you that it'll be in the same place as the last 12.
If you're just here, give me grief, I can get
that. Stand out of it, sunshine. I've had enough of this. Come for a walk. Clear your head.
Yeah, that'll fix everything.
You found him, then?
Yeah, it wasn't hard. Just looked for the nearest ratty red sofa.
What are you talking about? My sofa's in storage.
Well, with your sense of humour, it seems.
Yeah, lowest point I'm at in a long time, you want a joke.
It's how we work. You've forgotten that. You start thinking too seriously about what we get up to and it's going to end badly. Trust me on this. Me and Sol didn't exactly skip off into the sunset, you know.
Now there's a thought.
Isn't it just?
So what did you do then?
Ah, I'm glad you asked for that. I quite heroically moped around the salvage yards.
And?
And while I was there, I couldn't resist looking at our classified Jovian tech. It's fed us some sort of filaments for all the salvage from clear skies. I guess that's how it worked so well, and while those bits survived the explosion.
So he comes and gets me saying, bring a welder.
Yeah, because when you connect the Jovian tech up to all the other salvage, the filaments sort of do all the hard work. Things just spring into life.
Things? What sort of things?
Well, there was I with all this Mimitar ship salvage around me. Some construction robots sat idle and nothing better to do.
You've rebuilt her. God, Sol, she's beautiful.
Welcome back, John.
Don't break it this time.
You've got the best of two Tempest hulls, everything from clear skies that wasn't destroyed, and parts of Malsum that got salvaged. It works, thanks to all the Jovian tech, but it shouldn't really. It's about four different ships.
No, it isn't.
It's far from finished, but it flies. We've got all the new control gear off the Maelstrom, and a couple of other things besides.
Such as?
Well, with our track record, I made sure we fitted a damage control unit like most modern ships. Now hull beaters get sealed over a force field rather than us having to poke rocks in the hull like cavemen.
Nice one. Anything else?
I can tell you what we don't have, a micro warp drive, not after what happened the last time.
Yeah, the last time. I'll never be able to repay you for all this, Sol. Not just the ship, but everything.
I'm your friend, John. It's what friends do. Ah, I've got another surprise.
About time you showed up.
Oh my God, I don't believe it.
Hello.
My sofa.
Oh.
Oh, hi, Sasha. You even put my sofa on. Sol, you're amazing. Have I ever told you that?
Once, maybe twice. Only when you're drunk, though.
John, I need to talk to you.
I'll go see Charlie. You kids play nice now.
So what brings you here, then?
It's about Tarquin.
Oh, well, this'll be short, then.
We tracked down the power supply.
If you're about to ask for any sort of help whatsoever, that bridge is long burnt.
But what happened behind you? Lives are at risk.
Of course they are. Usually ours.
There's a bigger problem as well.
Go on.
Smith and I dropped scan probes in about 100 systems looking for that power supply. We found plenty of junk. Wrecks, cans, wormholes, but we finally got a hit. Here in the Masoya system.
And I'm guessing it wasn't as simple as going there and asking for it back.
No, because when we jumped into the system, we found a capital ship fleet covering the gate. There were wrecks or ships all around, and the local comm was filled with pod beacons, distress calls, and a station broadcasting a siege alert.
It would appear we are late, Sasha.
Who are they?
We can only assume they are the ones with the power supply, and something even larger is charging up.
It seems to be coming from that Proteus cruiser.
I've just picked up a signal jammer. Oh, and three interceptors heading our way.
Time to leave then, Miss Killane, and report our findings.
Tarquin!
It appears I won't be joining you on the other side.
Wait! I'll come back!
No, Sasha. There are too many and there is no time to waste.
You must jump through and contact Admiral Eisen. Go now and tell him what...
I left him.
I'm sorry, Sasha. I know how much he means to you.
Tarquin gave me chances no one else would. My life would have been a lot different and probably a lot shorter without him.
So, what did this Admiral Eisen do?
He responded, but not quickly enough. The Sinosaur jam was already up and running. No capital ships could jump in.
Leaving conventional ships against capitals? Nasty.
John, there won't be normal ships going in either. Just after I jumped back out, the gate connection went offline.
Offline?
It went dead. No uplink, no matter stream, just off.
I've never heard of a gate turning off before, never.
Both the Masoya gates went off.
The system's cut off?
Yes, and it's a main route from Ethereum Reach to Metropolis. Traffic now has to go the long way round or risk pirate space up north. But the bigger problem is if this effect can be duplicated, whole systems can be held to ransom or simply dropped off the map. Our way of life will be over.
I can see where this is going, and we're just one ship session.
Tarquin was captured, not shot at. I need your help to get into Masoya and get him back.
I really don't...
If you're worried about payment or...
No, it's not that, for once. Look, I can't see this being anything but dangerous, and I've only just got the ship back. Heart and soul of my crew are in it. And without them, and without clear skies, I don't know where I'd be right now. And the first thing you want me to do is to risk it all, again? I don't know if I can do that. I'm starting to feel my mortality, Sasha. We've beaten the odds a lot, but we aren't going to win them all.
Smith was my only contact to any resources. I'm on my own. You're all I have.
I'm going to have to think about this and talk to the guys.
Please hurry. I'm asking you as a friend.
I didn't know we were friends.
Well, consider yourself told.
Yeah, I always like that about you. Hey, Heifer. Yeah, I know. I only ever show up when I need something. Well, this time, it's just advice. So, dilemma. I didn't do too well after, you know, that stuff between us. We lost the maelstrom. I know. It was my fault. I got complacent, and it took some pretty harsh words to hammer that home. I nearly lost everything. But Sol and Charlie rebuilt Clear Skies and brought me back, and I owe them so much for that. And now I have to decide if I risk it all again to help Sasha. I wonder if that's fair on us. But we're all she's got, and I can hardly turn my back on her after all that's been done for me, can I? So, I guess we go. Decision made. Thanks, Haf. You know, you never did talk much, did you?
Rourke, you are cleared for undock.
Copy that, station. Thank you.
No problem. That a new ship, John?
I have no idea.
Must be Minmatar then. Have a good flight. Station out.
The wingy bits are square.
It was a choice between no heat sinks and square heat sinks.
I've heard the old ones.
Well, if you've got some lying about, feel free to bolt them on.
Yeah, I'm all out. So, does any of it work?
All the important stuff does, but I've got a mountain of bug fixing to do.
Anything I can help with?
The doors could do with some attention.
Ow!
So, I found some of your favourites.
You got 1400s on it. Oh yeah. New interface too. And a probe launcher. What do we need a probe launcher for?
Launching probes.
And what the hell is this? A YF-12? That's a bit old school, isn't it?
They were already on one of the hulls I salvaged, seeing as I paid for them, I thought, well, I might as well leave them fitted.
Yeah, but a YF-12? These things are dangerous.
Well, that's rather the point, isn't it? You're gunnery, not sociology.
Sol, can you pop over the cargo bay, please?
What, may I ask, is this?
You know, when you take something apart and put it back together again, there's always a few bits left over.
All sorted, Fallon. The gates are off, the Sinojammer is up. Masoya is all yours. Welcome home to the planet of whatever.
Haven. And the local population?
Just a bunch of miners. One look at your dreadnought fleet made them crap their pants. They'll give us no more trouble.
Good, good. Well, you certainly know your business.
I certainly do. I also know I've now got about 6 months of tedium. There'll be a heavy presence of the law on the other sides of those gates for now, but that's not sustainable, so once they run out of budget, we can cycle that thing and let me and my men out while no one's looking.
Yeah, and everybody else who wants to leave as well.
No, you can do that on your own time, my man. I'm first out the door when the gates come back online.
I know, I understand. The local population is my responsibility.
And what about our nosy guest?
Well, he's an old man in a suit.
He can't cause any trouble here.
Don't worry about him. It's quite harmless.
So, you'll help Sasha?
Of course I will. It's not me you got to worry about, though.
I know. Sol rebuilt this ship. How can I ask him?
Bang, it's coming. Follow my lead.
Your lead?
What do you mean, no?
I
can't believe you won't help.
Won't I? No, I won't. The help.
Won't help what?
He won't help Sasha.
Help her with what?
Picking up Smith.
Well, it's dangerous. Paint's not even dry on the ship.
Doesn't want to get his new ship damaged by helping poor old Sash.
Hang on, she asked for your help?
Well, yeah.
And you told her no?
Yes.
What, without him discussing it?
Well, I didn't think that...
After all the help you got recently?
Exactly my point.
Well, that's just... I don't know what to say, John. That's really poor.
I'm sorry, guys. I guess I was being selfish.
I guess you were.
So I'll tell Sasha we'll help after all, then.
Absolutely. Shame on you, John.
She'll appreciate that. What with the massive enemy capital fleet and the lockdown system we've got to get into. Nice one, Sol.
Thanks. Wait, what?
So yes, we all decided to help.
Thanks, guys.
So, what's the plan?
Plan? Well, the power plant's in a system of Masoya, which is now cut off. Question is, how do we get into a system with no working gates?
Easy. Carriers and dreadnoughts can jump in using a sino.
A sino jammer went up before the gates went offline. They aren't that stupid.
Yeah, I suppose there's an old acceleration gate leading there.
Unfortunately not.
Well, the only other way I know of then is through a wormhole.
Whoa, I'm not sure you even want to consider that.
When we were out scanning for the power signature, our probes picked up other things as well, including... I think... There, an active wormhole in Masoya. Can we get in through that?
No, we can't.
Why not?
Look, wormholes lead to wormhole space, right? Some chunk of space that is otherwise completely separate to us. Thank you, Charles. So, to get to Masoya, filling up Monstrosity would mean entering W space in exactly the right place to find it.
I thought all the holes are kind of clumped together.
Yeah, that's true, but there are still a lot of separate holes. Finding enough accessible hole that leads to the same clump would take weeks. And of course, there's the sleepers to worry about.
Well, I've got the probe results of all the systems we scanned.
Ah, bring up the ones wormholes in.
There, 17 of them.
Can we work out where they lead to?
You can see the stars and nebula of the destinations through them.
So if we see the same stars and the same nebula...
It'd be in the same place. There, the hole in Oimo leads to the same place.
So we go there, hop through two wormholes.
It's still not
and...
that easy. The hole has to be stable enough to carry all the ships we need, and we actually have to find an exit hole once we're in there.
We've got a probe launcher, remember? Something about it launching probes.
You're not helping. And the sleepers.
It looks like the Oimo hole is stable enough to fit about two ships through, then it'll fold up. That'll do.
Wait, two ships?
We can pick up my interceptor on the way.
Am I hearing you right? Two ships against a capital fleet? Charlie, why have you conned me into this time, you fuck?
What did he mean, fundamentally flawed individual?
No idea, I'm sure. We're about halfway to Oimo. Just stopping off to get your ship, Sash. Got through the defence fleet yet?
Yes, finally.
You to Admiral Lyson now, Miss Culhane.
Miss Culhane, no new developments to report at Masoya, I'm sorry to say.
I have one.
We think we can get in there using wormholes.
Risky proposition, ma'am. Are you sure?
Of course you're sure. We'll try and light you a sign on the other side.
And you are, sir?
Charlie Fodder, the good ship Clear Skies.
Charlie Fodder. Charles Fodder, right? It is, isn't it? From the Presidential
Gardener list.
Some time ago, yeah. Now happily do my own thing, thanks.
So it would seem. Well, you're in good hands there, ma'am. Mr. Fodderite, if you can gain access to the Masoya system, it would benefit you to rendezvous with our unit already there. Let me transmit the details.
Thanks. Oh, it's Malozzi. How about that?
What, you've met before?
Yeah, briefly.
Well, Commander Malozzi was there on routine patrol when all this kicked off. He's nicely hidden in a safe spot. Apparently all long-range sensors and probes are banjaxed from whatever caused the gates to stop working.
Nice to know. Right, we'd better be off.
Happy hunting. Oh, and Charles, We do have a rather more appropriate selection of battleships available, if you wish to transfer over.
I'd rather be on this ship with this crew than any heap from your fleet, matey. Trust in the rust.
Tough, but are susceptible to electromagnetic disruption, flying swarms, and apparently they can dissolve your hull in seconds. You see?
Nasty.
Are we talking about ex-presidential guards?
Very funny. No, this is the reason why wormhole space is considered dangerous.
Is this the sleepers you kept mentioning?
Yes. If you ever wondered why artificial intelligences are banned, this is it. Some idiot made one, it self-replicated, and started trashing the place, then legged it through wormholes when people tried to kill it off.
Are they called sleepers because they're slow and easily avoided?
Don't be daft.
Of course not.
No, they're called that because they were dormant, but we woke them up by poking around in their space and nicking stuff. Now, they're angry.
So, avoiding them would be a good idea?
Absolutely.
We're almost there.
Oh, bad news.
What?
The wormhole's still here. And it's stable.
But how is that bad news?
Well, it means we're actually going to go into it. Oh my word.
Just when you used to gate travel.
Yeah, that was rough. You okay, Sasha?
Fine, thank you. Found our way out yet?
That wormhole should be here. It should be easy enough to find. Get the probe launched and get scanning as soon as you can. Get yourselves moving. I thought you were a prof- It shouldn't be affecting
Good
you this
grief.
Much.
Got anything yet?
A headache. Okay, I've got the return at last. Getting us into warp now.
Whoa! What was that? Sasha!
I've hit something. My ship's damaged.
I've got pings appearing all over. This doesn't look good.
The wormhole's dead ahead and it's going our way.
Come on, come on.
Oh, crikey, it looks like sleeper drones.
Move it, JR. The hostile count's off the scan and they're closing in.
John, I can't get my engines online.
What?
Hitting that drone hurt more than I thought.
We'll turn...
My guns still work, though.
What are you doing?
Getting their attention away from you so you've got a clear run to Mazoya.
Wait, we're coming back.
You can't stop all these. There's too much at stake to worry about me. Just go.
Find Smith and get rid of that Jovian death trap before it's too late.
I can't leave you.
You've got a job to do, Captain.
You have to.
No! No, I will not leave another friend to die. Charlie, lock up the closest drones and get firing. So I'll start charging the YF-12.
Are you sure?
John, what?
Shut up and get ready to transfer over.
They pop easy enough. There's just too many.
Just cut us apart. Sasha, get in.
Come on, Sol! Do you want me to go and cheat him and buy some batteries?
Sol, I can read their chassis numbers. Come on!
I'm on board!
Sol!
It's still charging!
Smartphone charge.
Done!
Got him! Get us through the wormhole before they regroup!
Commander Malozzi of the Magellan welcomes you to Masoya.
Hell of a welcome. What were you doing parked there?
My apologies, John. We were briefed by Kaldari Command as to your exit point, but not, it appears, your exit speed. I was expecting two ships.
My ship's gone, but I'm still here thanks to John.
We're here to try and get Smith back, see if he's figured anything useful out.
It appears he has, but we don't know...
You heard from him?
Yes, ma'am. He hacked into the station's systems and got a short message pulse out to us.
Let me replay it for you.
I believe we should reach the Magellan, scheduled to be on patrol here at this time. I cannot transmit for long. Suffice to say, if you manage to board the station, I can guide you the rest of the way. I have information that will go a long way towards ending this.
That's all we received.
He's alive! We need to go to the station now!
Hold on. I don't care how much sensors are messed up by all this interference. When we roll up, they'll still see us through the window.
I have a stealth bomber available, John. It should let you reach the station undetected, but after that, it's up to you. There isn't enough room on board for any Marines. Are any of you certified to fly cloak?
I am. Let's go.
Sol, stay on the ship and look after it. Charlie, start packing some guns.
Ooh, which ones am I allowed?
Sasha's angry. Bring everything.
Okay, once we dock, they're going to know we're here, so it's going to have to be quick.
You sure about this?
It's a backwater station with poor security. They haven't had time to upgrade anything, and no one's expecting us. Trust me, I know how they operate.
Yeah, seems like I've heard that before.
Ah, it seems you were correct, Mr. Rourke, that I would need friends the next time I saw you.
We haven't got long. Where are you?
Fortunately, very close.
Continue down your corridor and turn left. I have set off a fire alarm in a fuel storage area, which has nicely distracted my guardians.
Clear left.
Clear right.
Second door on your left.
The door's locked.
Yes, it would seem my captors thought of everything.
Well, this should help then.
What the hell are you doing with that?
Well, you said bring everything.
Okay, Tarquin, you may want to find something to hide behind.
And what would you suggest?
Don't worry, this is a shape charge.
What sort of shape?
Spherical.
Most undignified.
You really have to work on your rescues.
I don't know if anyone can still hear, but there's an alarm going off. Let's go.
Ah, a stealth ship. That explains how you got in.
I'd worry more about how you get out.
Please, everyone, stay calm. There's no need for violence. Now, who are y'all?
I'm Captain John Rourke of the Clear Skies, and these are my friends.
One of which you kidnapped, along with the rest of Masoya. So, who are you? And what gives you the right to do this?
I'm Fallon Houseman, and miss, that planet, Haven, is our home. Or rather, it was.
Was?
Haven is a hostile place. It was unclaimed until our ancestors settled there. We led a hard but good life until we discovered a major Zydrine deposit near our colony. It should have been the answer to all our problems when we sold the rights to Otherworld Mining, but it seems we signed the contract in haste.
And they ripped you off.
Well, the contract gave them rights to the site and the surrounding area for development. Surrounding area ended up meaning our entire colony, and we were firmly informed that our presence was no longer necessary. Oh, we attempted to fight the situation, of course, but everything was legal. So we used our payment to buy ships instead. And we left in shame. Our ancestors' dreams destroyed.
If you could house your whole colony in ships, you could have easily moved to the station instead.
Oh, come now, John. We're colonists. Folks like us are hardly material for living in a station. You know that. So we became nomadic. Traveled the great wildlands. Demencia. Canid. We survived mostly on the proceeds of mining rare asteroids. But we also developed a talent for deep space archaeology. generating a significant income from selling the artifacts we found. However, the Empire Wars caused a mass exodus from the inner worlds. Suddenly, there was a great deal more fighting over all that territory. We were chased away, jump after jump, system after system, invariably ending up in a bitter fight with the inhabitants of the next place we stopped.
That's life in zero security space. If you have to simply out there, you're in the wrong universe, son.
Ooh, aren't you the hard case?
Come over here and say that.
You mess with me, you need a bigger gun than that, Sunshine.
God damn it, let me finish here. And we had two events that changed our course. One was finding the gate artifact on our last dig, and the other was hiring Ghost here to find a power source.
Oh, so it was him. Did he tell you how he got hold of that power source?
Yes, he did. He purchased it via contract from an anonymous seller.
It was on my damn ship, and he dropped out of warp and cut us in half to steal it out of wreckage, leaving us there to die.
What? Wait a minute, is that true?
Does it matter at this point?
You can take that as a yes. It's half the reason I'm here.
I'm sure we could compensate here. I mean,
oh, you are way beyond that.
But I didn't know that.
And what else has Mr. Mercenary here said to you, I wonder, to get you this far down a dark path? Tempted by the smell of Zydrine crystals, were you?
You watch your mouth, Rourke.
I'm sorry, John. If circumstances were different...
What circumstances exactly? Getting taken for a ride doesn't justify warping in all guns blazing. Well, actually, sometimes it does. But not when you attack people who had nothing to do with it. That's crossing a line.
No, Otherworld Mining crossed the line. They took our planet.
Did they? The story you just told me says you sold it to them. Okay, you lost out. A lot. And that's a harsh life lesson for anyone to learn, no doubt about that. But you need to look in the mirror, because what Otherworld didn't do is come in here with a fleet, kill everyone who opposed them, and cut the system off from everyone else.
We didn't... It wasn't like that.
And they aren't in the dangerous position of having mercenaries call the shots either.
Okay, I've had enough of this. Drop the hardware, ladies. Easy. You're going somewhere out of my way.
You can still stop all this. Turn everything off. Jump out. There's got to be 100 systems.
We've come too far for that, Fallon. No turning back.
Yes. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry, John.
You carry on down this path. People are going to die on all sides.
No, I am sorry, John, but Guy is right. We've come too far. We've invested too much.
Don't do this.
Already done.
He's actually stabilizing.
What the hell was that?
It's the same thing that holds clear skies together.
Gaffer tape?
Hardly, Mr. Fodder. Repair nanites, designed for advanced ship modules. When blended with Jovian technology, it can fix organic tissue. This was a test sample we had prepared.
Well, looks like it works.
The sample was key to humans. It seems your captain and your ship are now closer than ever.
Tell us what you know, Mr. Smith.
Their sinosaural field jammer is located here, at a small undefended starbase around the moon. If we remove that from the equation, the Kaldari Defence Force can jump in and resolve matters decisively. Our one and only focus must be disabling that jammer.
Yeah, those things are heavily shielded. So what firepower have we got?
Well, there's that sodding great thing.
Aye. Somewhat lacking in guns, but plenty of fighter wings on board. What else?
Clear skies.
My stealth bomber.
And that's it. So, some fighters, 6 howitzers and a couple of really big bombs.
What's tactical say?
I've turned it off. It's depressing me. Any more bombers on board, Malozzi?
Unfortunately not. We were here as a routine patrol, so standard loadout only.
Okay. Now, if the fighters attack the jammer, we can't use the bombs as well without risking friendly fire. And this ship is, for once, the most underpowered thing we have.
The hostile fleet is currently at the station, guarding the gate artifact quite closely. However, once we commence an attack on the jammer, Mr. Fodder, I would surmise that most of the fleet would be upon us within moments.
Yeah, and that'd be game over. Damn it, we haven't got enough firepower to take it out quick enough.
Distraction.
What?
John, what are you doing? You should be resting.
Forget it. Smith's things are working wonders. Okay. We need someone to distract their fleet while the rest of us give the jammer a kicking.
The only guaranteed way of engaging the fleet's full interest
is to engage the fleet itself.
And the Magellan is the only ship here capable of that.
You're massively outnumbered. You go there, chances are you aren't coming back.
I'm fully aware of that, Charles, but we are out of options.
With the bomber and our guns on the jammer, you'll only have to get their attention for a couple of minutes.
What in the seven hells is that?
Whatever it is, I can't get a scan of it.
Ah, I was concerned this would happen. I suspect my employers are less than impressed about the situation and have dropped in for a word.
Good. We can tell those Jovian freaks that... hello? Are you Jovians? Yeah, it was given to us by one of your agents. Hey, I didn't misuse... Yeah, but not a... I can't, you see. Would you shut up and let me speak? Okay, now, I haven't got all of your gear and... Yes, I know. I'm trying to get it back. In fact, can't you just go and get it yourselves? Oh, right. Simple as that, is it? Well, that's both me and you, mate. Yeah, and what's it wired up to, eh? What shut down the gates? Who exactly left that drifting in space for 1,000 years? Because it wasn't us! Is this more of your messing about with our development, or are you just forgetful in your old age? I ain't finished! Now, your tech allowed me to stop some madman from killing everyone in a station a while back. Now, I lost my ship, and I lost a good friend doing that. And if you think that was a misuse of your technology, then you damn well better step in this room and tell me that to my face. Right. Now, I'm not giving you anything back. Not yet. Right now, I need this ship, and I need these people to try and fix what's gone wrong. You can see me after the smoke clears, if there's any of us left. Yeah, I understand.
What the hell was that?
A message from our sponsors. Apparently we're on a time limit. Let's go.
Commander Malozzi to all crew, you have been briefed on the situation we find ourselves in and why we are heading straight to the enemy fleet. Make no mistake, we are outnumbered and we are outgunned.
Our task, here and now, is to get the
full attention of every one of those guns and stand for as long as possible. I know you won't fail me. Malozzi out.
Someone tell me precisely where the hell that thing came from.
Don't know, mate. Jammer's still up.
It must have been here all along. This damn interference!
They've launched fighters.
Get the dreadnoughts into siege mode and start hitting it. And launch your own damn fighters. Last time I checked, we had some.
Captain Rourke, we've engaged the fleet. Commence your attack run.
Gotcha. Let's go, guys.
Wings 1-3, ready for launch.
Go ahead. Full capacitor power to the shields. Inject when ready. There it is. Charlie, target.
Got sentry guns on our case.
Quite undefended, you said.
Perhaps I misread the plans.
Sasha, all the guns are firing on us. Do your thing and do it fast.
Sir, the shields have passed the warning threshold.
Engineering, spin up the drives and prepare for emergency warp. Captain Rourke, we're under heavy duress. What is your situation?
Met some unexpected resistance. Taking our guns off the jammer. We need more time.
How much more?
Charlie reckons about 2 minutes.
Very well. You'll get your 2 minutes, Captain. Make good use of them. Bridge to engineering. Cancel warp and stand by. I repeat, cancel warp and stand by.
Breach on flight deck 3.
How many more birds still in the air?
14, sir.
Get deck 1 clear and launch everything we have left.
Sir, engineering is reporting the warp drives have gone offline.
Duly noted. Let's see if they can restore them.
The shields aren't going to hold much longer.
In fact, I'm very well aware of, Ensign.
But, sir, with no warp drive, how do we escape?
Our escape was always a luxury, miss. And circumstances now dictate is one we can no longer afford. I'm sorry. Today we find out what doing our duty really means.
It's almost dead, but I'm out of bombs!
Charlie, hit that jammer!
Over to you, John.
Commander Malozzi, we've destroyed the jammer. Commander Malozzi, come in. Please respond.
John, they're gone.
Damn it!
I'll contact the defence force when we're in warp.
You drop that sino and then you go, understand me? You get safe and you cloak up.
I'm sure I could.
That thing's made of tinfoil. I want you safe.
Okay, but only because I'm out of ammo, don't think you can order me around.
Incoming communications from the Masoya system, sir.
On screen. Miss Colleen, tell me I have good news.
Sir, the jammer is down. I'm about to light a sinofuel for you.
Now transmitting the tactical data Commander Malozzi recorded.
And what of the Magellan?
Lost, sir.
Thank you, Sasha. All ships, all ships.
Prep for jump with immediate combat readiness. We will be dropping into a hot situation. Engage targets of opportunity until ordered otherwise from Field Command Tactical.
Cloak up, Sasha. We're about to drop in.
Incoming warp signature, Ghost. Two ships, sir. No, hang on. One ship.
Oh, come on. We just got rid of the last idiot. Are they lining up or something?
That's a lot of ships.
Have we gotten into this time?
Look, it's just an old battleship. Hold your fire and open comms.
No. Something isn't right here. Why send in one big boat for us to chew on and then roll up in that bag of nails? Oh, you're joking.
Surprise! No kill bonus for you.
Shooting you was pleasure, not business.
Rourke, now you need to stop this. Please, I don't want any more fighting here.
That's not your choice anymore.
Oh no, half a Tempest is threatening me. I'm deeply concerned. Wait a minute, where the hell's my jamming field? Rourke, what have you done?
Sasha, it's time.
Time for what?
Jump!
It's Hot Drop O'Clock!
God damn it!
Oh, no, this isn't right.
Thank you, Mr. Rourke.
We'll take it from here.
Glad to have you in system, sir.
It's not supposed to happen like this.
Okay, start locking up targets on my calls and focus fire. Trank, get your ass into a fighter and pot that Tempest. And you, don't you panic. Keep it together, man.
Launch fighters!
Charlie, hit the support ships. And Sol, scan out that Proteus. I want my power plant back.
They're falling apart. I love my gun.
Keep on hitting them.
Plenty of targets.
Shields are holding out fine. We appear to be on the winning side for once.
Changing mag!
Sir, fire control reports the Doomsday Beam is ready.
Thank you, Ensign. Tell them sand carrier on the way.
Sir, we've just lost a Ken Roberts.
The Proteus is the other side of this lot. We've got to go through.
Only we had a Michael Warp drive.
Shut it, Fodder. We've got half the bullets I'll have to do.
I'm going to get you now, Rourke.
Picked up two fighters on a tail. They're too fast to hit.
We can tank them. Just don't get hit by anything big. What did I just say?
Status.
Shields are barely holding now. We can't take any more hits.
Well, that may be a problem.
Get us out of here! Warp off!
Too late for that.
Don't accelerate towards them! What are you doing?
Trust me. I'm Captain... John... Rourke! Fast. Charlie, all guns front. Sorry, girl.
Ah, crap!
Good grief! He's actually got a use!
Now I remember why you're captain.
Two more of our ships have stopped responding, sir.
This wasn't supposed to happen.
Well, it has. Suck it up.
No! It's too much. Open a channel to them.
What are you doing?
I came here to give my people a safe home, but I've lost more of them in the last 5 minutes than in the last 2 years. No more. It's over.
Sir, Admiral Eisen responding.
Admiral, please, this has gone too far. We surrender unconditionally.
Glad to see you finally come to your senses.
Consider yourself under arrest. Power off. Unload all weaponry and lower your shields. Prepare for boarding parties.
Broadcast to the fleet, please. Everyone is to stand down. We surrender.
Accept all directives from the Kaldari fleet.
And I'm so sorry that I let you all down.
You aren't wrong there.
Ghost, please.
I save it. I'm not interested. Thanks to you, what's left of my crew out there are going to serve time. My reputation isn't going to be worth a unit of Tritanium. And on top of that, I expect I'm not going to get paid. So, if you don't mind, get your backsides into the escape pods. I'm taking this ship, and that junk is now officially my retirement fund.
Running for it.
Get on him. For once, we're the fastest thing around here.
Locked up and in firing range.
Hit him!
Shields down.
Hit him again!
His binders just went offline. I'm feeling atmospheric venting.
Finish it!
I'm out!
What?
No more shells. Sol!
Well, I wasn't expecting a full-scale war, was I?
Damn it, if he makes it to a gate, all this is for nothing. Pump everything we have into the thrusters.
I've boosted by about 20%.
No, I need double the power.
Double? Well, we can do it if I shot everything onto that bus, but it'll probably burn half of them out. What is it, Adolf?
I'm gonna hot dog it.
Hot dog? Hot dog? You can't hot dog in a bus. Oh, what am I saying? You're gonna do it anyway, aren't you?
Son of a...
He's coasting, so are we. We've blown navigation.
We've still got a shuttle on this thing, right?
Yeah, but what's that got?
I'm going over. Stop him once and for all.
What about us, then?
I need you two here, covering me. Put in a resupply request to the fleet and get the guns and engines online again.
Take too long.
No way, that can't
be. You, gunnery. You, engineering. Me, responsible for what happens on this ship. None of this would be going on if I hadn't let them jump us in the first place. And that happened because we got fat, complacent and slow. And that's my fault.
I'm not letting you walk away from us again, John. We near lost you last time.
You wonder what I do here other than stare out the windows? Well, it's this. Get my ship running again, because if I can't stop him, I need you capable of firing on that ship until there's nothing left. And besides, I've got unfinished business over there.
Hey! My ship may be a wreck, but I still know when someone docks. You amateur.
Oh, come on. I've had bits of my ship hit me harder than that.
Enough of this.
It's going to take over 10 minutes to get a supply of ammo over here. How are the engines?
Not fixable in the next 2 minutes. Hang on, I've got into his systems. Oh no.
Why are you still doing this? When everyone else has given up. Your cause is over, it's finished.
Yeah, all I need is one shot.
Finished? Maybe for those chumps, but not for me.
One shot. Wait, let me fire up Bob.
I'm a mercenary, my man! A gun for hire! I haven't got a cause. The only thing I care about when it comes to those losers back there is that I never got my goddamn money!
How about that?
Saber armor piercing? Perfect. Get it to gunnery fast.
Now this... this is priceless. There's nothing like it on the market. I'm gonna take it as payment while your friends are all preoccupied cleaning up that mess.
That thing's more trouble than it's worth, I promise.
Oh, I don't intend on owning it for long.
For a shot like this, it's gotta be done manually.
But we're drifting. I can't stabilize it.
Lucky for us, I'm a good shot then.
Good shot? Charles Fodderite, ex-presidential guard, this has to be the best shot of your life.
Oh, and thanks for the shuttle. And I think I'll take your ship as well.
You might find that last part harder than you think.
Yes, you do appear to be remarkably resilient. It seems I should have shot you through the head the first time. Let's hear it for second chances, huh?
Best shot of my life.
John Rourke, captain of the clear skies and major pain in the ass. Any last words?
Yeah. Take your best shot.
Goodbye, Mr. Rourke.
Breach detected. Emergency forces deployed.
Yes!
John, are you okay? John?
Yeah. It's a little damp. It's over. The power plant's secure.
Well, I think I can safely say, after the mother of all shakedowns, the ship appears to work okay. What's up with you? Gate's back online, ship's more or less intact, job done.
Yeah, that's the good news.
And the bad is?
Well, remember that little visit I had from the Jovians? It was about them getting their stuff back.
Isn't their stuff the only thing holding this ship together?
Yeah, I just got a message from them. They're not going to take Clear Skies apart, they're just taking the whole ship through that.
What? It took me months to put it together again.
I'm sorry, Sol, but there's no arguing with these guys. And face it, getting this tech out of the universe can only be a good thing. You guys understand that?
Suppose.
Yeah, I do. It's just after all the work and all she's been through with us.
Yeah, well, thing is, they want all their tech back.
Wait, you mean what's
in? Yeah, unfortunately their stuff's kind of holding me together as well.
They can't take that. You can't survive without that. They can't do this.
Sasha,
I won't let
them. Sasha, they know, okay? That's why they gave me a choice.
Which is?
To go with them through that.
What's the other side?
I don't know.
I can't believe you're accepting this. You're just going to go.
I'm sorry, Sasha. I wish I could stay. I wish I could stay with you.
Mr. Rourke, their patience wears thin.
This is so rushed. I'm sorry, guys, but you need to leave now. The shuttle's ready to take you to the station, and from there, well, I don't know.
So this is it?
So this is it. It all had to end one day.
All things do, Mr. Rourke. All things do.
Well, certainly has been an experience flying with you, Captain Rourke.
And you, sir. And Solomon, thanks for doing all the work.
Yeah, well, someone had to.
Fly safe, John.
Always. I still have my ship. And I still have my sofa. I love my sofa.
Any room on there for us?
What are you still doing here?
Oh, come on, we can't leave you to have all the fun.
Universe of adventure out there and all that.
Besides, you could get into trouble dressing in the morning, never mind being an ambassador for the human race.
Yeah, you need us.
Yes. Yes, I do.
And you certainly need me. So, Captain John Rourke, part human, part Jovian, and now all mine. Any clouds on our horizon?
Nah.
Offline.
Sol?
Yeah. I don't know about you guys. I don't know about you guys, but I'm feeling a little bit emotionally drained. I feel like someone's been playing an accordion with my chest for the last 3 hours. And that's kind of Ian's fault.
Sorry about that. I'm pretty drained myself. This has been, like, spectacular. This dude's is like 10 years since I did these. And to seeing what's going on there, in all the points of, rescuing Sasha and Meloz's sacrifice and all the hot drop of clock, obviously. It's just been, like, truly one of the best experiences of my life, I have to say.
I'm so glad. So glad that you could join us for it and experience it because, I don't know, I'm sure Clear Skies is something that you're going to be internally proud of, but you must wonder sometimes if, like, you know, folks have moved on, does anyone remember it? Those kinds of things?
Yeah, well, sometimes I do, but I'm always reminded by all the Eve guys and the fans and stuff that it's still around. I actually expected after one and even two that other people who weren't working by themselves would have picked up what I did and run with it and made such better stuff. But I guess no one else is stupid enough to spend so many thousands of hours doing this business.
Speaking for myself, I would think that the bar was just set so high because of all the extra work that you had to do into that. It wasn't just like frapsing some Eve space vision and stringing together narrative. You had to do like mocap and sound editing and build sets in Half-Life and things like that. It was epic. Like, how do you even top it?
Yeah, I learned a lot, and the credits got a bit silly because it's basically like my name on everything, yeah. And it's like I feel a bit of a dick just putting me, that was me, and that was me as well.
That's how it was.
Yeah, it was. But I mean, I had a lot of help from other people. There was the guy that built some of those spectacular, massive sets. Someone did that for me. Samantha did all of the lip syncing. She helped me. I actually did a horror film a couple of years after doing Clear Skies 3 because I wanted to try something different, see if right. I could achieve anything. So I did a horror film called Ticket Zero. It was good. The issue mainly was it took 5 years to make because I got married and I had two kids during production, and that really does bugger up the amount of free time you have, I can tell you. And at the end of it, it was good. I liked it, but I never loved it. Whereas Clear Skies, I loved, you know.
So with that one, you mentioned that you had like help along the way. I think there was a CCP developer who assisted you in particular on Clear Skies 3 to get those space scenes looking so amazing.
Yeah, Robin Whitehead. He couldn't actually give his name at the time, so at the end of the credits when it says Prawn, he knows who he is. That's Robin Whitehead. He actually makes the trailers now, I believe.
And I heard a story about that fight scene as well.
Oh god, yeah. So that fight scene, well, it only lasts 13 seconds or whatever it was. That was blocked out by me and Richard Powell's and the motion capture, and we sort of did it in we didn't want it to last forever because we wanted a realism in inverted commas, you know what I mean. I tried to take the stance of JR was going to be a barroom brawler, and what's his name, Ghost, was going to be more trained,
a bit more finesse, like your classic kind of mismatch.
Yeah, I tried to get it across in the little time that I had. But the issue with it, because I was using markerless optical motion capture, only I could be in front of the capture cameras. So I had to do both sides of the fight by myself, the blows, the reactions, everything. And it absolutely broke me. The next day, I got delayed onset muscle stiffness literally all over my body and my right arm from swinging punches at thin air, that I got an overextension injury. And then like two the day that the DOMS really kicked in, 2 days later, I had my second date with whom is now my wife. And she's like, what's wrong with you? And I was like, how the f*** do I explain this? Well, this is a long story.
I really want this girl to kiss me one day, so how much should I tell her? Yeah.
Yeah. I swapped that tale, and she told me how she leant over a bedroom light once and her boob flopped onto the light bulb and burned it. So, you know, we traded stupid injury stories and the romance blossomed from there. She'll be really pleased I told you that.
I bet she will. In fact, I'm going to clip that after the show.
So your ringtone.
Yeah, right. Use that to blackmail you.
It was really great fun doing the fight. There's a lot of clever camera cuts and cutting to hide just how badly nothing matched up.
I'm sure a huge element of it is how much you can get away with, not just what you can do on purpose.
Yeah. Who we got? The Mac Cloud. Quick question. You spelled my name wrong. What do people put R in? Any TV or films whose influence? Well, I guess subliminally, I suppose. But I didn't do it going, I want to make Red Dwarf in space. It's just like British humour tends to, and it's in space that I get a lot of comparisons. There's that. If you don't mind, I was just going to answer a couple of queries that I can see coming up in the chat, if you like.
Oh, no, absolutely. No, these guys aren't here to listen to me talk.
Berak, out of interest, what you do in real life? I work in IT. I deal with enterprise security now for a company called Ping Identity, who are actually doing an awful lot of good work around the world at the moment, helping people work from home securely. Do you think it's time almost 10 years we return to the story? Dude, they're stuck in, like, Jovian space. That's a good question by Glasgow D, but I always said that with Clear Skies, I had a story to tell. And by the end of Clear Skies 3, I figured that I had told that story. But I mean, the good news is I am working on another film project, but I've definitely moved away from the Half-Life 2 engine because it's a ropey old bag of crap, really, considering what you can do these days. So I've bought iClone, a dedicated animation engine, and a whole bunch of other stuff, and I've spent an absolute fortune on it, so hopefully people will like what I do next. If you want to segue on to something...
Do you want to take a few more questions, or did you want to talk about
that? A few more questions. Anyone got a question? I'm just saying. Have you been or will you be at an EVE meetup? Nope. I have. I went to FanFest a long time ago, but I've got wife, kids, job, etc. I don't really have time for much else, especially driving around the country and stuff. Any celebrities reach out to you? No, sadly. Do I need voiceovers? No, thank you. Thank you for the thanks. Thanks are good. No, I don't still play EVE, mate. It was too much of a time sink. I get like half an hour to an hour and a half a couple of times a week to play games now, so I just play co-op stuff online with my friends. Where are we? I was pretty rubbish at EVE. I'm much better at pretending to be awesome in films. What inspired me to make first Clear Skies video? I covered that off at the start. It was messing about and finding I could chroma key in EVE footage onto a Half-Life 2 set. In EVE, was my involvement in EVE. I was rubbish at it. I would basically get ganked at gate camps and emo rage quit. Are you into cars? Yes, I am. I had a Toyota Supra for many, many years. That's why the hull designation is 2JZ GTE, and then that became a rolling thing. All the hull designations are engines, engine codes. I can't keep up with the chat, so I'm going to have to skip a few. Sorry. What was the best speed I got out of my Supra in 10 of the best? 184 miles an hour. Do I still talk to the crew and actors? Yes, they're all my friends. Yeah, pretty much all of them. Richie and John. I work with Dan. He works at Ping Identity as well. Andy Carter, he's on this chat now. A whole bunch of them. What we got? Do you base scenes around the music around the scenes? Combination of both, a lot, a surprising amount, is of the plot and the scenes are driven around a nice bit of music that gives me an emotional lift. There are probably half the music in each film, the scenes written for that music rather than vice versa. How do I keep my motivation going? Because I don't want to let people down. I'm not a Billy Bullshitter. If I say I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. And when other people invested time, like doing the voice recording, which is the second stage, first is the script, second is the voice recording, when they've put their time in, I nearly gave up on Ticket Zero so many times, especially when I had a RAID disc failure and I lost all of the motion capture I'd already done.
Wow.
Yeah. But yeah, 5 years later, I still did it. A Mini with the same plate? I don't. I drive a Jaguar XKR, thank you very much, sir. 5 litre supercharged V8. How dare you?
It's not a very Mimitar car.
CCP Aura. Could you describe the steps of going to making something like this? Yes, but it takes about an hour to describe. It is unbelievable. People don't get how involved it is. Let me give you an example, right? I have to very carefully think about my file system on the computer and the folders that I store things in and naming conventions. It sounds dull as, and it is dull, but you need to be organized for a project that takes 2 years or more and involves like 500,000 files. And I'm not joking. You need to be able to find your stuff and you need to know what it is. And I write like mocap schedules for myself. I did. So they're like just a page of like this line, this person does that from there to there. This person does that from there to there. Boring stuff like that. Because I might be doing that motion capture 18 months later. I can't remember what people are doing in the layout of the set. So I just follow a script that I wrote for myself a year and a half ago. So there's a lot of boring admin stuff, and there's so much stuff you have to do before you can do anything fun, like, you know, recording video. And even set building is like a real bore. Like, okay, Ian, can we get it? It's hot drop o'clock.
That seems to be pretty popular. You better do
it. Yeah. Yeah, I haven't said this line for a very long time. It's hot drop o'clock! Probably woke the kids up.
Yeah. Worth it. We'll make it up to you somehow.
What went into recruiting? What went into recruit? Thank you.
That just destroyed chat.
Yeah, I know, right? What went into recruiting the cast? It's my friends. I had to get people around that I knew and I could explain stuff. When I was doing Clear Skies Run, they hadn't got a clue what I was talking about. You know, and getting them to maneuver the ships around as well in the game. They're just like, oh, it's like, you go there, and then you fly past, and I'm going to record it. And they're like, what are you doing? This is so tedious, you know? And it was only when they started seeing the stuff being put together, they're like, I can't believe you did that out of that. So it's an awful lot of, I get all the stuff in my head, and I need to get it out. And make the film. So all the stuff you see in the films have been festering my skull for like 3 or 4 years. Going back to like my friends, yeah, I just sort of figure out who's good for stuff, whose voice I think would fit, and a lot of the people I know, they've got an imagination, and I can sort of, you can bring things out of them by knowing their life experiences. And so, for example, if I need an emotional response from a female voice actress, I need someone who's got kids. Because, man, you know the highs and the lows that kids bring you. You can tap into that. The joy, the anger, geez, the anger. And then the emotional upset of like, oh my God, what if something horrible happened to my kids? You know, you can tap into that sort of thing. That sounds probably awful, but you know what I mean. The voice casting for Ghost, well, you know, that was unbelievable. I have some of my friends that were in Clear Skies 3, they were mad on science fiction conventions, and they went down to one in London. And Francis Capra was there for doing Veronica Mars, I believe it was, he was representing. and they were doing round tables afterwards, and Francis just said that he was looking, he was a mad geek. He was well into World of Warcraft, and he sat there, and my three friends were sat around the table with him, and he just said, like, "Oh, I'm really actually looking to get into some voice acting. Now, I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the term machinima, but I'd love to do something with that." And like, there was a look shared between my three friends, and they were like, "We have someone you might want to speak to," because I just finished the script for Clear Skies 3. Poor old Andy Carter, hope for son, on this chat. He was originally doing the voice for Ghost. I dropped him like a hot brick. I'm not ashamed to say, because when Francis Capra wants to audition for your whatever the hell this is, you know, that's bonkers. I practically teleported down to London the next day. And I had my script with him, and we went through it. And sorry, I'm a bit disturbed. My Supra's number plate's on a Mini because I've got the same private number plate on my current car, so I'm hoping it's not cloned. So I hand him the script, and he's looking through, and Francis bloody Capra says to me, "Oh, I'm really nervous." And I was like looking at him and I was thinking, like, well, I know exactly what I was thinking. We have an expression in our family called the long U. And the long U is when you're outwardly calm, but in your head, you're going, "Far!" And you get, that's the long U. Yeah, so that was crazy. He was over in Los Angeles. It was a really stressy nightmare because he was a bugger to get hold of. And I didn't think it was even going to happen. But finally, he actually went round to Ricky Grove's place in LA. And Ricky does voice acting, so he had all the gear. And so Francis and Ricky recorded their stuff together. So that's like, wow, that's crazy. Also, I'm one step closer to Kevin Bacon now. That's brilliant. So my bacon count's gone down one. That's great. Right.
Zeroing in on it. There was another question asked in chat before, saying, are you working on a new sci-fi film? And you did mention to me that you have a project, and we've got something if you guys want to check it out. Are you happy
see what you think.
Spin that up.
Yeah, you might as well. All yeah, right. See what you think. Don't all be right. too disappointed. All right.
All right. Go for it.
To the Bathurst Medical Facility on Sobaseki Station. This is the long-term recovery suite for serious trauma and primary bodily injury. When you feel able, please speak your name for Medicom identity verification. Thank you. Please speak your name for verification. Please speak your name for verification.
John. John Rourke.
Confirmed. Welcome back, Captain Rourke.
What's in Divinity's Edge? Where the hell?
So, how many of you saw that one coming? Twitch chat seems to be a bit excited.
Oh dear. It's a couple of years away, guys.
Yes, but I think
just, you know,
I think everyone would agree that, you know, this is to us, based on how we feel about the last Clear Sky series, that I'm perfectly happy for this to be a when it's done, you know, like
it's going to be when it's done, right? Yeah.
So just, can you give any context at all about what's happening in the clip? Because you probably don't want to say anything about the story, but how this is coming along compared to, you know, previous Clear Skies, your new methods and so forth.
I've changed everything. It's an iClone. You can see the graphical quality is just bonkers better. It's got a new way of lip syncing, face posing, animating, camera control, building sets, everything. There are things are faster to do by an order of magnitude on all the horrible grindy stuff, and that's what I needed. Yeah, everything except cool edit. yeah, new mic, new compressors and digital audio and things like that. I've got to upgrade my PC yet. I've worked out a lot. I'm going to need 2 terabytes of mirrored SSDs.
Wow.
Just to store the raw footage, because I'm recording it in 1920 by 1080 uncompressed. So like the drop on this is probably about...
You need support with that kind of stuff. I think the community would be willing to get behind you.
Well, yeah, I mean, I had this discussion and I kind of felt like as soon as money comes into it, it can get a bit funny sometimes. I understand.
Like you were saying before that you've basically done all this for free and it's sort of it's been a relief for you. You know, it's one thing you have to worry about. And then the obligation, of course, that comes with that.
Yeah, and the expectations and stuff. It's like, dude, I gave you money for this and it's rubbish. Yeah, I don't want that sort of taint, that sort of thing to happen, possibly. I'm not saying, you know, like 99% of the people, they're all lovely guys in the chat, apart from that one guy, but we won't talk about him. But they're all lovely guys. I don't want to let anyone down. And I am in the fortunate position that my career and everything means I can pay for this stuff myself. The wife's not hugely happy dropping probably about £5,000 on it far for all the hardware and software. I've got a fantastic new motion capture rig, though. It's Neutom's Axis Neuron, so it's some 31 magnetic sensor suit. It's fantastic. Yeah, so...
Well,
it's all new.
I would love it if the timing all works out and the film is ready around the same time that we're having a fan fest or one of our other major player gatherings, and maybe we could get you along and have a proper premiere with red carpets and penguin suits and
well, hors d'oeuvres and that'd be super duper. It just depends on when it gets finished, you know. It's big, I'll tell you that. The script is twice as long as Clear Skies 3.
Twice as long.
I couldn't make it any shorter.
That's like 4 hours. Are you even going to...
4? Behave, it's 2.
Is it? I thought Clear Skies 3 was about 1 hour 20. Did I get that wrong?
Twice as long as 1 hour 20.
240 minutes. I mean,
man.
Man,
didn't we have a time zone discussion?
I'm bad at this in 24-hour times, so forget about it. Sorry, I don't know where that came from. But yeah, that is still a long movie. Are you planning... I mean... It's probably too soon to ask these kinds of questions, but are you planning to release it in like one part or?
Yes, it's going to be one part because I make it. I make bits as I can make them. It's not done sequentially.
Right.
It will be finished. But the thing is, the workflow with iClone, I mean, like the lip sync going, I literally point a webcam at my mouth and, you know, there's a lot of calibration up front. But once you've got it, pretty much you can record the lip sync in real time. So that's crazy good. The face posing is easier. Everything's done in real time. I don't have to compile maps. I don't have to rebuild XYZs and reload the map and try again. It's just right there. You scrub up and down a timeline. It's really good.
So it's taken 12 years, but finally the industry has caught up with your vision.
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, it's got its own foibles and quirks, but my God, it's so much better than the Source engine, and the quality's better. It's trucking along at the moment. I built that scene that you just saw mainly because it was a great scene, not only for this kind of thing, this teaser, but also it taught me the motion capture, it taught me the face posing, the lip syncing, new workflows, the physics engine when JR staggers and clatters the stuff.
Knocks things around, yeah.
Yeah, the motion capture, all of that business, I've got them through and built it. There was going to be a bit of compositing, but... Robin, who is, by the way, doing all the exterior shots, Robin, that Whitehead, the CCP head of video and trailers, actually, without him, this would be a non-starter because he can't decouple Jessica from the databases anymore.
No, unfortunately,
No, I thought it was dead in a ditch, and I just said, unless you want to do them, lol, and then he bit my hand off. So that that one precise, unless you want to do them, lol, was the life or death for Clear Skies 4. Nice. And luckily it went the right way.
That's so good. I'm glad that CCP is supporting you in that. Even if it's not officially CCP, that would be Robin helping you as a passion project. So.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not CCP back.
Sorry, I mean, I just have to walk that back because we shouldn't be taking credit. He's doing that because he wants to support you.
Yeah, yeah. He loves Clear Skies. He said nerdgasm when I was like, are you sure? Do you realize how much you're taking on? And he's bang on for it. So he'll be doing that in his own time. Obviously, CCP are very supportive of this sort of thing, but they can't get too involved due to the nature of the projects for various reasons.
Oh, well, for my part, I'll certainly be looking for ways that we can support you again in the future. I mean, just doing the stream, obviously. I mean, what has it meant for you to see, you know, we had like, I think, 1,200 people at one point with chat going nuts at all the right moments. Like, how does that make you feel when you're sort of thinking about this project ahead of you?
I was not joking when I said this is one of the high points of a high experience of my life. That's just seeing all this. It's like 10 years on and there's still this much. That's just amazing. And one of the mistakes I made with Ticket Zero was I thought, right, I'm going to use a royalty-free licensed music. So I actually went through the ball ache of getting licenses for the music, which also meant I couldn't do my usual trick of picking music I wanted and to fit the scene and all that stuff. So that, hey, I can enter it in competitions and, hey, I can put it in film expos and all that. And it just didn't work. So this time I'm like, screw all that. I'm doing this for the fans, for you guys. That's who I'm doing it for. And to get these damn stories out of my head.
Well, your torment is going to be our gain. So thank you for all the you know, thousands of hours that you've poured into this over the years, because you've given so much like joy and camaraderie to the community through it. It's been absolutely awesome.
Well, they're interesting times we're in at the moment.
Yeah.
So it's nice to be able to distract people from it for a couple of hours.
Exactly. Like, this is probably those kinds of moments when the true value of your work, you know, can present itself. It takes it to goes to a different level beyond just being merely entertainment, you know. This has brought everyone together to enjoy this and have a shared experience. And that's probably one of the biggest compliments you can give to any artist.
It was one of the best things about it was it didn't matter if you're Minmatar or Galente or Amarian or all the other ones. Caldari, that's the fellas. Everyone liked it. It just crossed the borders of all the factions and conflicts. And I made sure it pretty much stayed apolitical and all that because no one... It's not relevant. It's got to be relevant to people who don't even play Eve. You know, it's a wider audience. And it's like, it seems to have struck a good balance there.
Yeah, I think you've absolutely nailed it. Well, Ian, our stream has just ticked over the 4-hour mark. It's been...
I think they want the trailer again, mate.
All right, we'll give you... I'll play the trailer again on the way out. But there's also... I'll play the trailer next. But then to actually close out the stream...
Let me just answer Ad-G about social media. I'm pretty awful about social media stuff. I've got a Facebook group called Clear Skies. You're welcome to join. In a couple of weeks, I might get around to adding you to the group. It's very rarely updated because if I could be updating the page, I could be working on the film. And the film usually wins out just to manage expectations. I'm not particularly chatty online.
All right. Well, let's spin up the trailer now one more time. We'll come back real quick and then we'll close it out.
Okay. Thank you all. You have changed my life for the best. Thank you.
To the Bathurst Medical Facility on Sobiseki Station. This is the long-term recovery suite for serious trauma and primary bodily events. When you feel able, please speak your name for Medicom identity verification. Thank you. Please speak your name for verification. Please speak your name for verification.
John. John Rourke.
Confirmed. Welcome back, Captain Rourke.
What's in Divinity's Edge? Where the hell am I?
All right, we're back. Well, I guess that's it, friends. We're at the end. So before we finally sign off tonight, I've got one last thing I wanted to play. Manic Velocity. Last night, there's an EVE Online chat show that happens on Twitch, Ian, called Open Comms. And I just happened to stick my nose in a chat the other night around the time that they were talking about this event that was happening. And Manic basically told all the other hosts to shut up so that he could absolutely gush about how important and awesome Clear Skies is, and he mentioned to me that he had the Clear Skies 3 DVD, and he tweeted out today a photo of his signed Clear Skies DVD cover, which I thought was really cool.
It's got a signed one, cool.
Yeah, and on the Clear Skies DVD is a blooper reel from Clear Skies 3, which is hilarious.
Oh, yes. Yeah, love the blooper reel.
Yeah, it's so good. So I thought it would be the perfect way to cap things off. So I'll spin that up in just one second. Ian, is there just any parting words you wanted to say?
Only that this blooper reel represents just like how hard it is dealing with unprofessional voice actors. That's all. It's really good fun. My mate John, who does Charlie Fodder, says that doing the voice recording for my projects ranks in some of the most fun things he's ever done in his life. So that's really nice. And yeah, I love the blooper stuff. So let's go. Let's do it.
All right. And for my part, thank you guys. Thanks everyone for tuning in. I've had an absolute blast doing this. I'll leave that on the behalf of the community part, because Ian's been able to see exactly what the community thinks all night long in Twitch chat. You guys have been massively supportive. Thank you so much. And I'll see you guys around.
You have released one of the most dangerous artifacts I know of into a hand. Oh, you That's really annoying. I was there and I got AIDS.
Bucket!
And you keep having to say, I'm Captain John Rourke of this year's ship.
And so it begins.
How did we ever record the other two?
Are you ready?
That'll be a no.
I'm fitting that, I'm fine. To start, I'll be alright.
Right. Okay, once we dock, they'll know we're here, so it's gonna have to be quick. Band! Get out!
It was imperative part of the deal. Do you realise something with what the sentence ends?
Maybe we should get back at the station and sort that sentence out.
I'll put my fee up to two beers. Although you might be able to buy me off with two cream eggs, I don't know.
My God, you... Oh, f***. The pressure's on and he bins it. All right, let's go through it again.
Again?
Yeah, at least two good takes. So two to go.
I now have a staggering amount of damage to I now have a staggering amount of damage to control.
Oh, you f***.
I now have a staggering amount of damage to control. Oh, I'm going all... Oh, it's going to be my... Yeah, all right, one sec. One more line. Okay. I now have a staggering amount of damage to control... Oh, God's sake. I now have a staggering amount of damage to I think... Why is it I can't get that word? It's just control. There it is, look. Control.
You're control freak.
Right, start up top again.
He's nicely hidden in a safe spot. Apparently all long-range sensors and probes are banjacked from whatever's caused the gates to stop working.
Hardly, Mr. Fodder. Repair nanites. Designed for advanced ship modules. When blended with Jovian technology, it can fix organic tissue. I almost restarted. Do you mind?
I thought you had an hernia.
I was.
No, because when we jumped into the system, we found a capital ship fleet No, because when we jumped into the system, we found a capital ship fleet covering the bloody f***ing gate, didn't it?
I believe this should reach the Magellan.
The parent of the guns! No, that's wrong!
Oh my God!
Very well. The damage has already been done. I am a Jovian agent. Dun, dun, dun! Who would have guessed?
Let me transmit the details. Don't stop me in the middle of a line.
Myself and a Tempest battleship crew, it's all that we can get fit through the hull wormhole before it stabilises.
And other words.
Myself and a Tempest battleship crew, it's all that we can fit through the wormhole before it destabilises. I can't say it any other way.
Okay, we'll get back. I can't even remember what he said. Right.
It's all that will fit through the hull before... all that will fit through before the wormhole destabilises.
Okay, try that.
Myself and a Tempest battleship crew, it's all that will fit through the hull... Just...
You heard what he said.
Did I? I ain't finished! Now, apparently I am.
I've heard a few things in my time about them, and all this fits.
Well, that bus through that gap.
And the Magellan is the only ship here capable of that.
One more.
How hard is it just to string like 20 words together?
Scary, isn't it?
Move it, JR! The hostile camp's closing in and they're off the scale.
I don't know, but can we please discuss this back at the station? Only I'm starting to get the heebie-jeebies out here. The heebie-jeebies.
Jesus.
I'm getting the heebie-jeebies out here. Sure I am.
What sort of shape?
Spherical. That was a bit too much. Oh, spherical.
Engineering, spin up the drives and prepare for emergency warp. I can't say drives properly now. Where the f*** did I get that one from?
However, once we commence an attack on the jammer, Mr. Fodder, I would surmise that most of the f***ing fleet would be upon us within moments.
Why is it we've got more in the bucket than we have in the real thing already?
This is how we roll.
Oh, yeah.
Now this is priceless. Nothing like it on the market. I'm gonna take it as payment while your hole in your paper disrupts your line, Francis.
Rah! Beware my wrath.
The Prophius is that's a bad word. The Prophius is.
Go ahead. Full capacitor power to the shield. Inject when ready.
Yeah, I'll cut that out.
The wingy bits are square.
No.
Just no.
Sure. How old are you? 14.
No. We can tank them. I haven't read all that line yet. Hang on.
Incoming warp signature. That's going to take some work, isn't it? Incoming warp signature ghost. Two ships. No. There. Incoming warp signature ghost.
Warp signature ghost.
Incoming warp signature ghost. Two ships. No. Hang on. One ship.
No. That's no good. So good up until it. One ship.
Incoming warp signature ghost. Two ships. Warp signature. Yeah. Why can you put like little words in for me?
We can do it if I shunt everything onto that bus, but it'll probably burn out after. What's this in aid of? What am I doing? What am I saying? Let's do that again. We can do it if I shunt everything onto that bus, and it'll probably burn out. This is, I can't do this line. It's rubbish. Hang on.
But sir, with no warp drive, how do we escape?
No. It's
gone telling you what. You b***ing, you're killing us all.
Right.
F*** you, I'm leaving.